And now, it's time for the Friday night game of the week on the Varsity Sports Network.
Tony, of course, we're going to get ready for the national anthem. We have Tyrion Arnold, Jalen Herring in midfield getting ready for the coin toss. And so we're going to jump out, do a little radio business. Of course, a little internet business as well. Of course, run some commercials. We're going to come on back, and then we'll have the intros and the kick here at the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week. It's the second half of our doubleheader, Tony.
Yes, sir.
Live from the north side, Chiles and JP2. Take care. We'll be right on back.
Welcome to Big Core. This is Big Core. I would like for everybody to come out to my restaurant, come enjoy my country cooking in the city of Tallahassee. I'm a country boy and coming to the big city to give y'all great food, great atmosphere, great staff, great service, great everything. On game days, birthdays, parties, any days that y'all want it, I got it. I'm gonna put all the other restaurant chains to shame. I specialize in fried chicken. Best fried chicken you will ever eat in your whole life. I promise you that. Come on down to Big Core's Country Cooking, 1812 on South Monroe, walking distance from FAMU. I got the food, everything ready for you. 850-383-8227.
Let's get back to living and let White & Snow Cleaning and More help you along the way. White & Snow Cleaning and More is committed to a higher standard of clean. Our staff is both professional and dependable. Whether it's residential or commercial, no job is too big nor too small. Call us for a free estimate, 850-866-2031. White & Snow Cleaning and More is committed to a higher standard of clean so you can get back to living.
If you're looking for a great opportunity to expand your brand, here's your chance of a lifetime. The Varsity Sports Network has all kinds of advertising packages to fit your budget. The Varsity Sports Network, 1 million viewers, 150,000 views per month, and our Friday Night Football Game of the Week is also heard on ESPN Radio. Our advertising packages start for as little as $50 per week. Expand your brand with the Varsity Sports Network.
Getting ready to blast it off, of course, for John Paul II here. Tony is big Antonio Jones. And back and through the end zone, so how about that leg?
And here comes the pitch. And it's going to be a play. It's going to be a running play. He's going to have the outside. He's going to get the first down. He's going to turn the corner. And he's going to be bumped out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. And that's number 5, Wilshire, on the carry. He's going to pick up about 12 yards on the play. It's going to be a flag on the play, though. Let's see what happens. No official indication as of yet. It looks like it might be going against the Timberwolves. And that's going to nullify a great run by Phil Wilshire.
Tony, that's one thing we're going to watch. Of course, this is part of a troubled offseason with these teams. You know, of course, not getting the typical regimen that they're used to, Tony. And, of course, just the youth movement going on, like we talked about, Tony. So a little bumps in the road. So something we'll see going forward here for those two teams. Because for Chiles, this is only game 4 of the season here, Tony. So we're still getting in that kind of September groove. So treat it like a September game here.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's going to be a mark-off against the Timberwolves. It's going to be a 5-yard penalty. It's going to bring up a second down. 15 yards to go. The ball is going to be marked at the 15-yard line.
So second down and 15 to go here for the Timberwolves. Like we said, going forward, it should be a interesting one to see how we get out of this situation, Tony. Staying on schedule for these offenses is going to be key. A little bootleg from Wilcher trying to get out in space. A good tackle here near side. Coming to rack him up is Makari Mickers here, the sophomore, able to make the drop, Tony, but good wrap in space there.
Yeah, that was Vickers on the tackle, man. He's just a sophomore, but he's a big one, 6'2", 182 pounds. And he was just able to drop Wilcher for about a 3-yard gain.
Yep. Absolutely.
Brings up a third down, 11 yards to go. Ball is going to be marked right at about the 19-yard line.
As they're able to keep on trucking, Tony, of course, they got to get out to right about the 30, so it will be about third down 10, third down at 11. So a little uphill battle going forward here. So an early test for this offense. Out of the shotgun, giving the pitch. Oh, a little reverse, a nice little inside action. Going to be short of the yardage to gain, but I like a little bit of the trickeration there. Christian Corbett, the man going to get it on the double pitch there, Tony.
Yeah.
Very creative.
Yeah, and he was hit real hard also by Vickers once again, who's playing wide receiver as well. Vickers is a big guy, and he's making sure that he makes his presence known in that secondary.
So fourth and two, and coach is going to, what we thought was, roll the dice here, and it looks like the offense is staying on the field. Wiltshire, the quarterback,
wow,
going to be maintaining here. And, of course, deep in their own end in the early going. And a little bit of jump, and maybe that's what they were going for,
that's
Tony.
That's exactly what they wanted, and it worked. So there was a little offsides infraction against the Panthers. That's going to be an automatic first down for Chiles.
Absolutely. Maybe that's what they wanted, man. Maybe that's what they wanted. Move the chains, of course, just over the 30-yard line to about 32. We're towards the center of the field. Of course, Chiles Timberwolves in all white. Of course, got the maroon helmets with the numbers on the side. Kind of that Alabama look, Tony.
Absolutely.
And on the other side, you got JP2 is going to be going right to left. Those dark, dark blue and gold up on the shoulders with the white pants. Snap over the head of Wiltshire. He's going to dive on it wisely, just trying to cover it up, Tony. But it's going to be about a 10-12 loss on the snap there.
Yeah, that was an unfortunate. It seems like he just wasn't ready for that snap, and that's going to push the ball back all the way to about the 20-yard line and bring up a second down and 20-plus yards for Chiles.
Absolutely. So it's going to be an uphill battle, Tony. That's one thing that both of these offenses really want to try to stay on schedule with these young quarterbacks, not having to get in a passing situation that could be obvious because we have some dangerous DBs back here. Number 11, Tyrone Arnold, and, of course, Makari Vickers, Zuarez, he do some serious damage over here on the near side. Pitch out to the perimeter, and beautiful tackle. It's another loss on the play. The one on the bottom of that, I believe it was Samaj James.
Well, of course, Samaj James is one of the stars for JP2 as well. Samaj James plays wide receiver as well as defensive back. 9 receptions, 232 yards. This guy's already had 2 touchdowns. And as we can see, he can hit you as well.
Yeah, it's going to be about 25 yards to go now on third down. They're going to have to get out their own 43-yard line, backed up to their own 18. So they're going to spread them out, go 4 wide receivers here for Wiltshire. Sidecar right is the tailback. He's going to bootleg to the right. Running back stays in a block. Delivery over the middle. It's intercepted. Samaj James going the other way. The old turf monster gets him. Football's on the ground. They said field caused the fumble.
So it's going to remain JP2's ball. And that was an excellent interception on the part of Samaj James. He went up and he grabbed that ball because it wasn't an easy interception to make, you know. That guy was firing the ball, and Samaj just with those sticky hands was able to hold on to it.
Absolutely, but a beautiful interception. Read it, and he was lurking. QB must have been looking next level. James just popped right up and ripped it out of the sky, Tony.
Yep.
Like you said, the wide receiver, of course, you know he's got good hands, so you know he's going to catch that one.
Absolutely, absolutely. So Samaj James, of course, with the interception, that's going to give the Panthers excellent field position as they're going to start this drive at the Chiles Timberwolves 20, it looks like the 29-yard line.
Or just inside the, right about the 29-yard line, just inside the 30. So here we go, Tremaine Hughes under center. Single back set, quick hitter out to Tyrone Arnold. Let him go to work.
That's right.
Gain of about 5. As he slips out to about the 24-yard line,
and that's
where he's brought down.
And that's what you call getting it into your playmaker's hands with the quickness.
Absolutely. Let him do some work. So there'll be a lot of quick hitters. And I'm interested to see how exactly they work Hughes in here. Does he go design quarterbacks? Did they give him a bunch of bootlegs? Because I haven't really seen JP2, like I said, but, of course, watched the stream of it when they were over in NBH and had a massive victory. And that one was not much of a game. Hughes out of the shotgun. Sidecar right is going to be Leon Washington Jr. And if you're an FSU fan, that is the son of FSU great Leon Washington. Quick hitter once again to Arnold out in the perimeter. Makes one man miss. First down and then some. He keeps going. Juke move to the inside. Spins inside the 10. And he's dropped right around the 6 or 7. And you can see, Tony, magic on the field. The big-time recruit doing some damage in the passing game. First down, JP2.
Yeah, I tell you what, man, Hughes was just able to pick up that ball and just run around the right-hand corner and picked up over the first down. He picked up about 15 yards on that play. It's going to be a first and goal to goal. Ball is going to be marked at about the 6-yard line, it looks like.
Absolutely. So inside the 10, it'll be right about the 8 over on the right hash mark. But the Panthers are surging now in the red zone. Here are the Chiles Timberwolves trying to get on the board first here on the north side. Hughes going to get his wide out on the end around. Looks to be slipped on the turf again. It was Arnold on the rush. Good wrap up, Chase Hartley, on the bring down there for the Timberwolves.
Well, I tell you what, we saw a lot of that last night, the little turf monsters, a little slippery field, and it could be the same situation here. We did have some rain a couple of days ago here in Tallahassee. Looks like it might be threatening to rain a little bit tonight, but not sure. We've seen a lot of slippage, though.
Yeah, absolutely. It wasn't heavy enough to seep through the turf, Tony, so I think it's just kind of that moist layer, almost like a dew sitting on the field right now, so it's really tough footing out there. That's a great point. Under center now from the 9-yard line. Second down and goal here for JP2. Hughes is going to fake the end around. A beautiful play design. And he saunters into the end zone. Jaden Jefferson, the junior tailback, puts it in 4-6. Tony, and the visitors take the early lead.
Well, I tell you what, that was a beautifully designed play. He almost fooled me on that one as he faked the end around. Was able to put that little counter play right into the middle. And he went right between the guard and the tackle, sauntered into the end zone, as you said, for 6 points for the Panthers.
Yeah, absolutely, Tony. That's a great play combination, because what did we see so often? Perimeter, perimeter, perimeter. They kept it wide in both the passing and the rushing game. So that's what the mindset of the defense is. Boom, you get Jefferson going downhill right down Main Street, and the combination gets him napping, Tony. Good 10-yard rush there for Jefferson.
So the point after attempt, as the Panthers have one late entry running onto the field.
Going to need 11 here, Tony.
Got to have 11.
Can play with 10 if you want to.
If you want to, but you would be at a disadvantage.
Usually doesn't work out well when you need 10 on 11.
Absolutely not. It's almost like playing 5-on-3 in basketball. Doesn't work.
They do have a penalty flag on the play. Don't know if it was inadvertent.
Well, it looks like they're going to pick up the flag. Here comes the snap.
High place. Snap, able to get it down. Kick on the way, but sails outside the upright, and it is no good. So we will stick to that 6-0 score line here, Tony. Here at the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week, we're going to jump out here for a quick commercial break. Come right on back here. Varsity Sports Network and WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio.
Welcome to Big Core. This is Big Core. I would like for everybody to come out to my restaurant, come enjoy my country cooking in the city of Tallahassee. I'm a country boy and coming to the big city to give y'all great food, great atmosphere, great staff, great service, great everything. On game days, birthdays, parties, any days that y'all want it, I got it. I'm gonna put all the other restaurant chains to shame. I specialize in fried chicken, best fried chicken you will ever eat in your whole life. I promise you that. Come on down to Big Core's Country Cooking, 1812 on South Monroe, walking distance from FAMU. I got the food, everything ready for you. 850-383-8227.
And welcome back to the Varsity Sports Network Friday night game of the week as the Timberwolves and the Panthers are getting ready to continue their battle as the Panthers have just scored their first touchdown and they have an early 6-0 lead with 5 minutes and 53 seconds left in this ball in this first quarter. Here comes the kickoff. It's going to be taken by James at the goal line. And he's going to be met. Oh, the ball is on the turf.
Looks like he hit the ground there, Tony. He slipped and went airborne. He was going so fast. It was almost like he started walking on the water, Tony.
Well, you know, he's a miraculous guy.
There you go. So brings it out. Good little return, though. Gets him outside to about the 21, favoring the left side of the field. So we'll see what the Chiles offense has. We'll see if they stick with Wilcher or we'll switch back to the other sophomore. Not exactly how the flow of things go here with the alternating sophomore quarterbacks, but it looks like Wilcher is going to come back out there for drive number 2, Tony.
Well, it's going to be marked at the 20-yard line. Second possession for the Timberwolves.
So a little max protect look, running back to either side. Wiltshire out of the shotgun here. He's going to hand off to Herring. Herring go to the outside to the left. He's twisted down over the 25. So a solid pickup of about 5 or 6. And there you go, Tony. Get the USF commit involved. And a nice little rush there for Herring.
Yep.
We're typically used to seeing him on the perimeter, of course, in years past. But, of course, with need be, he'll slip in there and play a little tailback as well.
Well, it was a nice rush. He's picked up 6 yards on that play. It's going to bring up a 2nd-and-4 for the Timberwolves. Ball is going to be marked at about the 26-yard line.
Yes,
call
sir.
It a 27.
And so that's where they will get rolling here, Tony. Of course, on 2nd-and-down for the Timberwolves here at home. This one coming towards us and then cut back against the field out to about the left hash mark, but some good yardage on the pickup. Once again, swerving in and out of traffic. I believe that was Herring once again on the rush. Giving about 4 or 5 yards, Tony.
Yeah, he's going to pick up a 1st down on that particular play. So the ball is going to be marked at about the 33 as we pause for a water break.
So there we go. A nice little water break going here, Tony. And so, of course, this evening we have a nice little water break sponsor going for us here, Tony. So we will pop up, and of course, that is Tall Timber Photography, Tony.
Oh,
seeing
yep.
is truly believing. That's why you need to see what's happening with Tall Timber Photography. Of course, they care about what's in front of the camera, and that is you, my man. That's why they have personalized consultations, every edit done by hand, so they're as unique as you are. No templates, no pre-made designs, or awkward poses. Family-owned and operated right here in Tallahassee, focused on capturing the perfect moment that will be as timeless today as it is 60 years from now. Next level shooting experience, of course, done at the University of Miami and University of North Florida, Tony. Bringing the big leagues to your capture-worthy moments. A little more from them after the play here. Herring out in the space, able to break outside and stopped just short of the 40-yard line.
Another excellent run on the part of Herring as he picks up about 5 yards on that play.
Absolutely, Tony. And, of course, a couple more words as we were finishing up from Tall Timber Photography. Whether it's high school sports, youth leagues, weddings, engagements, maternity shoots, they do it all. Check them out at talltimberphoto.com or visit their stunning social media content, Tony. I can't emphasize that enough. It's beautiful. If you like good photos and just appreciate the art, just go look at it, man. At Tall Timber Photo and at Tall Timber Sports on both Facebook and Instagram.
Right on. Outside the 40-yard line. See, they're going to spot it at about the 38. It'll be a 2nd down and about 6 yards to go for 1st down for the Timberwolves.
Of course, need to get to the 43-yard line, Tony. Sitting about 37. Here's they're going to try to stretch it out, go back against the grain. Jalen Herring once again continue to do work, continue to fight for the extra yards, and the USF commit gets up to the 45-yard line. Great movement surge forward there for Herring.
Well, that was that big offensive line just opening up a little hole for him, and he did the rest on his own, just kept those legs churning. If he's able to pick up the 1st down, the ball is going to be marked at the 45-yard line.
And this is what you want, Tony. Give him the ball, give him the ball. Offense, getting into a little rhythm here. Of course, staying on schedule, Tony. Of course, the penalty on the first drive derailed Chiles a little bit. But this is the momentum you want to see. Good to see a little progress here from the Timberwolves in drive number 2. High snap, Wiltshire once again to Herring, who's turning into a 4th down back, Tony.
Yeah,
this one,
he is.
He gets dropped just short of the C on the CHS logo at midfield here. So it'll be about the 45-yard line.
Yeah,
Tony,
no,
back to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, back to the line of scrimmage. It's going to bring up a 2nd down and 10 yards to go. Timberwolves have to get inside of the Panthers' territory in order to pick up the 1st down right at about the 45-yard line.
Yes, sir. Of course, just inside the right hash mark here on that 45, Tony. Of course, Chiles in all white with the dark red maroon helmets, looking like Alabama out here. Wiltshire design bootleg, but he's going to go ahead and run, trying to get the perimeter. Shakes through one, shakes through two tackles. He dives forward and give the sophomore 12 a beautiful pickup by Wiltshire,
yeah.
Tony. And when you get in open space, he just takes off, and you can see kind of what we've seen over the last couple of years, special teams, defensive back. When he gets an open space, man, just speed and elusiveness all over the place.
Yeah, Wiltshire just didn't want to be denied as he just put that ball as it was a design bootleg, as you said, over on the left-hand side, and he was able to pick up the 10 yards that he needed.
There you go. Bootleg, and they just kept on trucking, Tony. Nobody's open. Go ahead and run that ball, man.
Run that ball, man.
Took care of business. So move the chains. They now get onto the JP2 side of the field. And so continue to roll here. Of course, 6 seconds on the play clock. But 2:23 here in quarter number one. Ball over on the left. Dash mark of the 44 of JP2. Stoppage of play coming over from the far side.
Not sure if they're going to call that. There's going to be a mark off on that defensive end who
offside.
Just encroached. Yeah.
Offside, JP2. St. JP2, my mistake, Tony.
St. JP2, man.
Of course, re-emphasized about 2-3 years ago, the sainthood. And so out of respect, you know, we want to make sure we stay on top of that.
St. JP2, Panthers.
So first down and 5 coming here for Chiles. And over the 40-yard line, Tony, the farthest they've been in JP2 territory this evening. Ball over on the left hash mark, little max protect look. Backs to each side of Wiltshire. Give is to Herring on the zone look and eating up in the backfield. Great penetration there in the drop. A Johnny Mason, the freshman D lineman, able to make the drop there, Tony.
Yeah, just a lot of penetration on the part of the defensive line for the Panthers as they were able to get him stopped before he could get going.
So looking over the sidelines, going to be right about the line of scrimmage there. Of course, need to get to the 36, so it's going to be a strong 5. Week 6 there, Tony, to get the first down. Ball over on the left hash mark, just outside the soccer circle. Of course, on the turf, you get all kinds of fields painted up, Tony.
Yes,
we're using
do.
The white lines tonight.
There you go.
And a give. Nice misdirection again. Chiles using what JB2 did on the touchdown. And the ball is on the ground. It'll be interesting to see whether they mark him down or not. But a beautiful little rush up the middle of the field there. Christian Corbett, the man toting the rock there for the Timberwolves.
Yeah, he's going to pick up the first down, too. The ball is going to be marked at about the 31. And this is the farthest that Chiles has penetrated into the Panthers' territory so far tonight.
Keep on trucking, man. Hear the band start picking up. Of course, ready for prime time, ready for the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week. Of course, as always, simulcast on 97.9 ESPN Radio. Tallahassee Sports Monster bringing you the action today over the radio wave. Surging forward, Jalen Herring zigging and zagging through the middle. Pickup of 7 there. Continues to have success in between the tackles here, Tony.
Well, Jalen Herring has definitely been the workhorse tonight.
I mean, you can get it anywhere you want it, man. University of South Florida, they're going to play him at DB. They're going to play him at wideout. They're going to play him at running back.
Yeah.
Multifaceted, man. Love to see it.
So brings up a second down, about 3.5 yards to go. And there's going to be a flag on the play. And not
somebody's
sure.
Getting excited.
Yeah.
Looks to be a penalty on the D Timberwolves.
Yeah, they may have had 12 men on the field.
So, of course, they're going to back this one up, Tony. Could have been 12 men. So legal substitution. Yep. Mm-hmm. So could have broken the pocket with 12. Could have had a late break. Yeah, a number of things here that kind of not added up. Counting a quick count here. 5, 9, 11. Looks like they should be good on this formation.
Okay, let's see.
Watch Reagan's out to the far side, Tony. Yet to see him put it in the air. Should be interesting to watch. Play clock running down. Looks like we have a stoppage of play.
That's going to be the end of the first quarter.
And, of course, like you said, Tony, end of quarter number one. So we're going to jump out here for a quick commercial break on the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week.
Welcome to Big Core. This is Big Core. I would like for everybody to come out to my restaurant, come enjoy my country cooking in the city of Tallahassee. I'm a country boy and coming to the big city to give y'all great food, great atmosphere, great staff, great service, great everything. On game days, birthdays, parties, any days that y'all want it, I got it. I'm gonna put all the other restaurant chains to shame. I specialize in fried chicken, best fried chicken you will ever eat in your whole life. I promise you that. Come on down to Big Course Country Cooking, 1812 on South Monroe, walking distance from FAMU. I got the food, everything ready for you. 850-383-8227.
And welcome back here to the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week. Simulcast on WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio. You know it's Tallahassee Sports Monster. Andrew Juke, Tony Williams, Walter Weaver, Deanna Denoso, bringing you the action out here tonight. Tony, you wanted a score update. We asked about our buddies out in Monroe. You think 7-0 is in the cards, Tony?
Oh, my gosh. Monroe is taking care of business with a score of 22-0.
In the first quarter.
Rolling. I told you, those Bobcats are for real.
Absolutely, those Bobcats are for real, my friend. Lincoln up 7-0 on the Godby Cougars down at Gene Cox Stadium, down on the south side of town. We're up here on the north side, though. Second down and 10. Wiltshire give to Herring, trying to go back into the big side of the field, trying to find a little space. Spins out of a tackle, keeps on trucking. A fierce, aggressive run by Herring, and he continues to move the chains here for the Chiles Timberwolves, Tony.
Well, I have an unofficial rushing yardage of at least about 50 yards for Herring so far in this second quarter, which is just starting.
Getting rolling. Of course, yeah, like we said, just beginning quarter number two here, my man. And he's looking good, Tony. Will be interesting to watch going forward, see how far he can go, man. Give us the action here, Tony.
So the ball is going to be handed off to Herring once again right up the middle, and he's going to be trapped after about a two-yard gain by that big defensive line for JP2. It's like Enriquez on the stop. After a pickup of about maybe a half a yard, it's going to bring up a second down and 10 for the Timberwolves. The ball is going to be marked at about the 30-yard line.
So here we go from the right hash mark. The Chiles Timberwolves trying to continue to do some work. Why not? Herring again. Runs right up the middle. Tyrion Arnold with the wrap up, but he's going to get inside the 10. First down and goal for the Timberwolves.
Yeah, man. Chiles is continuing to do what that, hey, you gotta go with who brung you to the dance, man. And Herring is the one that brung him here, and he's continuing to bring him here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Absolutely, Tony. Absolutely. So, of course, like we said, set up down from the 10-yard line. So it will be first down and goal. So Wiltshire, the only quarterback we've seen out here tonight. He's got two backs in the backfield, one left, one behind him. Give is to Herring. Cut back towards the middle of the field, and Herring is tumbled down short of the goal line. But a nice rush, Tony. Give him about 7. They're down to the 3.
It's going to bring up a second down and goal to go for the Timberwolves as they are threatening to tie this game up. And with a successful point after attempt, take it to lead. 10 minutes, 11 seconds left in the second quarter. The Panthers, if you're just joining us, with an interception and a touchdown, but the 6-0 lead over the Chiles Timberwolves. But here comes the play.
And it dropped right around the line of scrimmage there, Tony. Not much doing there, so it's going to bring up a third down and goal as he going on the right side. And so it'll be a good fight here, Tony. Of course, Chiles trying to even the scoreboard, maybe even take the lead with the successful extra point. Of course, things get a little tighter here in the red zone.
Oh, most definitely so.
So, of course, Tony, this would be a great opportunity, maybe do something away from Herring. Maybe some Reagan's out. He's isolated out there, only receiver. It's going to be Wiltshire with the keeper on the right side, and that is beautiful.
Yeah.
It's in for a touchdown for 6, Tony. So they had, of course, Herring out there. They use him as the lead blocker. Design quarterback run to the right side. Herring with a full head of steam, able to create just enough for Wiltshire to get through. And Chiles is going to even up the score. 6 apiece here on the north side.
Well, I tell you what, we've seen Wiltshire run the ball throughout the night, man, and that's at least his second or third rush. And every time that he runs the ball, he's successful. He's picking up yardage, and that was a perfect call for a perfect occasion. And Chiles has tied this game up. 6-6, so the point after attempt coming up.
Here we go. Michael Smith is going to be on the attempt, Tony. Of course, we always talk about special teams in close matchups, man. This special teams conversion could give them the lead. Smith settles in. Of course, it's going to be 20-yard extra point. The penalty flag on the field for what it's worth. The conversion was no good,
but
if it's on JP2, he's going to have another crack at it.
Yeah, well, I think that that play was blown dead before he even had an opportunity to kick the ball.
Neutral zone infraction, Tony, so he will get another crack at it.
He will get another crack at it.
So we've seen a couple coaches, Tony, when we get a penalty on the extra point, they'll bring out the offense to go for 2, but it looks like they're going to leave the special teams out on the field. I like that. Give young Mr. Smith an opportunity to blast this one through, get the confidence up.
Yeah.
So we got the nerves out. No big deal. It doesn't matter.
Well, every point, as you said, is going to be premium tonight, man. especially in a close game like this.
So they're going to wind it up once again. Smith getting ready. Hold is clean. Kick is off and away. And he'll rocket good. This one through, and it's going to give Chiles the lead. 7-6 over the visiting JP2 Panthers. And I love
Saint JP2.
Yes, sir. Saint JP2 Panthers. And I love, Tony, when they get the wolf howling over the sound system here. I'm sure you guys picked that up. Of course, here we're outdoors with the people out here at Chiles High School.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, doing our part, a little social distancing ourselves, Tony.
Most definitely so.
So you know we got the portable press box ready to roll.
Yes, we do.
You know, you can't just roll up here with the equipment, man. You got to have all the goods because this is the game of the week, man. We're on ESPN Radio.
Oh, most definitely so, man. And it's an exciting atmosphere out here on a Friday night. I remember those Friday night games in high school on a Friday night with good weather like this. You can't ask for more.
Nothing like it. Tony, this is interesting. You call this good weather. We'll continue to have that discussion. But, Tony, I'm waiting for that late November.
Yeah. Well,
give me that Thanksgiving. Give me that regional final weather out here, man.
I
That's
know.
What I'm waiting for, baby.
Yeah, well.
Good old blast by Michael Smith on the kickoff. Go back for a touchback.
Well, you know what, Jupe? You know, at least you're in short pants, man. You're not in Maryland where it's probably 25 degrees, you know, next month. Wow, I remember those days living in Washington, D.C.,
yep.
And all of that snow. I'd rather Tallahassee.
You had your time, Tony.
I've had my time,
yes,
man.
Sir.
I have had my time, my friend.
It's good to get a little variety, you know?
Oh, yeah.
You live a little bit of that, you get tired of it, just like maybe being down here, you get tired of it, bounce around.
Go for a visit.
Broaden your horizons a little bit.
Yeah, you're right.
It's good to touch in here and there. So,
yeah.
But you've seen it all, Tony, so you know.
Yep.
You know you like snow. It's not for me, man. I'm sticking down here.
Exactly.
And that's why you've been in the capital city.
That's right. That's right.
So, of course, we got some big action going. Of course, big capital city matchup last night. Tony Rickards, Raiders, Florida High, Seminoles. Of course, Florida High proven victorious. Number 23 ranked team in the state coming into that matchup, Tony. Knocking off a big 5A school. Of course, an injury to the Rickards quarterback, Michael Townsend, really changed the narrative of that game. Rickards having the 7-0 lead. I talked to Coach, though. Coach Lewis says he's good to go. It was a precaution. So we're thinking that Townsend should be good to go next week, of course, against Leon. They'll play back at Gene Cox Stadium and get ready to rock and roll, my man. So, of course, good news coming out from an unfortunate circumstance. You never wish ill around any of these young men.
No, of course.
Of course, we love all our Big Band boys. So like them to stay happy and healthy, and when they can't, we hope they get back to that state as quickly as possible.
Absolutely. Speaking of Leon, you know, Leon is going to be playing Florida FAMU High tonight. Right down to first quarter, it's 0-0. St. Paul John II, of course, that's the game that we're on. Gainesville and Walcala War Eagles. First quarter, it's been canceled.
Yeah, that game was switched, of course. It was switched over, Gainesville backing out, and so they went, of course, with Columbia. So another one of our Big Ben teams traveling down to the Tiger Den having a football game. This one going to be stretched out to the perimeter, trying to turn the corner, lowers the shoulder, shoved out of bounds, but a fierce rush once again by Jaden Jefferson.
Yeah, Jaden Jefferson, of course, the running back, he's a junior, came in tonight's game with four touchdowns, and they're going to be giving the ball to him often and frequently. He picked up about 3 yards on that play. It's going to bring up a second down and 7.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Continue to move the chains. And this is a JP2 team. Give you a variety of looks, Tony. Like to mix it up. Of course, led by Coach Ed Hill in his second year of action. And the boys are looking good, Tony. He said he's building the foundation there brick by brick, Tony.
Yep,
and we can
Southwood.
See it. You can see it. You can see the mentality of the players, and you can see kind of the progression over the last 2 years. Coach Hill, the right man for the job, doing a good job out there at JP2. Jefferson once again on the run, heading back towards the middle of the field. A nice pickup to get him to about the 27-yard line. Set up a nice third down and about 3 or 4 to go here, Tony.
Yeah, well, if he can average about 3 yards per carry, then he should be able to pick up this first down on this next play. But, of course, the Timberwolves going to have something to do about that.
Absolutely. I mean, it's been a while since we've seen number 11 touch that football, Tony. It's kind of making me uneasy a little bit. We saw him, what was it, 6 straight plays he got a touch in on the previous offensive possession. Samaj James, the wideout down here near side. It's going to send Hughes under center. If you can hear the banging in the background. The Chiles faithful are stomping their feet. Jefferson trying to get outside, but a nice wrap up on the perimeter. He's going to be short of the yardage to gain.
Yeah.
And there you go. The Chiles defense going to step up and force an interesting decision here on fourth down.
Well, they're continuing to try something on that right side of the Chiles defensive line, and it's just not happening. It's run that play for about two or three times, but they haven't been successful at it. It's going to bring up a fourth down about 2 yards to go as JP2 is getting ready to punt the ball away. Deep to receive. Looks like it's going to be number nine for the Timberwolves. And, of course, that's Herring. Standing back at about his own 36-yard line.
High snap, able to be handed, almost blocked, but gets it away, bounces on the 38. Herring with a little bit of real estate. Stiff arm coming here near side, puts the brakes on, makes another man miss, and a great return out to the 43. And there comes the electric Jalen Herring on a good return, Tony.
Yeah, Herring just was able to pick up about a good 10, 12 yards on that particular play. And excellent punt. Also on the part of JP2.
7:26 to go here. Second quarter action is Chiles taking over on offense once again. Of course, their last possession ending in a touchdown. The quarterback keeper from Canary Wiltshire. And Chiles having the 1 point advantage. Each team with a touchdown. But of course, the extra point, Tony, which was originally missed. How big was that penalty? We would be tied at 6-6 right now.
Yeah. I'm telling you what, man, that extra point could prove to be costly. Wiltshire is going to hand the ball off to Herring once again. He's going on the right-hand side. He's going to be tackled after about a four-yard gain, but a tough four-yard run for Herring as he gets the ball up to about the 40, looks like about the 47-yard line.
He's brought down by Samaj James, another big player for JP2. Of course, wide-out defensive back. He already has an interception so far today. Of course, on the first offensive possession for Chiles was credited with a takeaway. So a second and moderate going here for the Timberwolves. Wiltshire out of the shotgun is going to go max protect. Look, running back to each side. Play action to Herring. Bootleg to the left. The right he's going to have to throw against his body. And he shakes out of a tackle here near side. And Wiltshire keeps on trucking. And he dives over the 45. Move the chain, Stoney. And that's just some backyard football, man.
Yeah.
Making something happen outside of the pocket. Fun to watch Wiltshire out here tonight.
Yeah, Wiltshire is definitely an athlete in the making, man. This guy's not a big quarterback, but he's elusive. And he's slippery, as you can tell, as he was able to shake that tackle and pick up an extra 10 yards on that play.
Slippery.
Yeah,
indeed,
he's slippery.
Tony.
Yeah. And so he's going to get into JP2 territory. The ball is going to be marked at the 45-yard line. And the Timberwolves on the move.
So there you go. Once again in JP2 territory. Kind of methodical, Tony. A lot of runs, a little different looks. Very different than what we were used to seeing the last couple years with Garrett Green as the quarterback. And there you go. It looks like that double reverse give to Herring. And then the other running back getting the handoff coming to the other side, Christian Corbett. And, Tony, I believe the second or third time we've seen the double handoff. Gain of one this time.
Yeah. Ball is going to be marked at about the 40, looks like the 44-yard line.
And we have 5:48 to go here, quarter number two. So another speedy game off and rolling here, Tony. Tony, what? We had a 48-minute first half last night.
Oh, wow.
That game was quick as lightning.
Yes, it
was. We're about at that point right now. So both of these teams, a lot of runs, making the game move very fast. Maybe they're trying to get out here before the rain, which is scheduled about 9 o'clock here, Tony. Give to Herring, full head of steam. Good blocking out in front of him.
He's gone.
He gets a first down and ends some. If not for Terrion Arnold, he may have turned that one into six.
Yeah, man, Herring is just really doing his thing tonight. He picks up about 25 yards on that play. And no flags on the field. Looks like it's going to stand. Ball is going to be marked all the way back, all the way down to about the 20, looks like about the 26-yard line.
Absolutely.
We'll call it the 28.
He keeps on trucking. So we have a little water break. We're going to jump out for a quick commercial break.
Welcome to Big Core. This is Big Core. I would like for everybody to come out to my restaurant, come enjoy my country cooking in the city of Tallahassee. I'm a country boy and coming to the big city to give y'all great food, great atmosphere, great staff, great service. Great everything on game days, birthdays, parties, any days that y'all want it, I got it. I'm gonna put all the other restaurant chains to shame. I specialize in fried chicken, best fried chicken you will ever eat in your whole life. I promise you that. Come on down to Big Core's Country Cooking, 1812 on South Monroe. Walking distance from FAMU. I got the food, everything ready for you. 850-383-8227.
And we're back here. Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week. Simon Kesson, WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio. Tallahassee Sports Monster. 7-6. Chiles on the prowl again, trying to add to the lead for JP2. It's all Wiltshire, the quarterback keeper here, left side, cutting back against the grain, down to about the 13-yard line. And give the dual threat quarterback, the young sophomore, blossoming, Tony.
Yeah.
Running before, machine. 15
right,
more.
Yeah, right before our eyes, man. A little naked bootleg on the left-hand side. And he's able to pick up a good chunk of yards. Ball is going to be marked at about the, it looks like about the 20, 15-yard line.
Absolutely, Tony. And this is the dangerous situation, Tony, because what you've seen is run, 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 run. So it's almost like Chiles is waiting for JP2 to come after him. So you got to be disciplined here for JP2 and not try to get burned over the top because the pass is coming, Tony. We just don't know when.
Don't know when.
And, of course, rush on out here to the near side. Maybe getting back to the line of scrimmage. Excellent pursuit by the JP2 defense.
Yeah,
there, Tony.
Yeah, you know, it gets real tough when you get closer. The closer you get to the end zone, the tougher it gets.
Major Hart the second, the linebacker, able to make the drop there for JP2. Young freshman, Tony. Seen a lot of freshmen on both sides making plays.
Yeah. Big boys out there, too.
Like we talked about, man, this is one of those youth movement games. Both these teams very young. But, of course, both back to their winning ways. Of course, Chiles getting the big win last week. This one is going to be a handoff to Herring, and he's weaving through traffic. He's got an avenue to get inside the five.
Still turning.
Still rolling. He'll get inside there to about the two or three. Move the chains. First down and goal for the Chiles Timberwolves, Tony.
Yeah, he just picked his way. He just weaved and bobbed his way through that traffic, man. Was able to pick up a first down and goal.
Little tempo, back to Herring. He's going left side again, and this time he's going to be able to punch it into the end zone. And Jalen Herring does it on the ground. One from Wiltshire, one from Herring. Now two touchdowns for the Wolves. And add to the total, Tony, now a full 7-point lead, 13-6 here in quarter number two, 3:33 remaining on the clock. And Chiles looking to add an extra point and go up by eight, Tony.
Well, if you can remember, that drive started at about the 42-yard line, and they just marched down the field, man, 64 yards into the end zone. And they're looking good. They're looking like where they picked off where they finished last week.
Extra point up and good. Of course, Tony, winning gives you a lot of confidence, man.
That's right.
And a confident bunch of the Timberwolves coming out here. Ever since the turnover, really locked it down. The run game has been very strong. We're going to jump out here for a quick commercial break, and we'll come right on back on the other side here. Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week. Simon Kesson, WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio.
If you're looking for a great opportunity to expand your brand, here's your chance of a lifetime. The Varsity Sports Network has all kinds of advertising packages to fit your budget. The Varsity Sports Network, 1 million viewers, 150,000 views per month, and our Friday Night Football Game of the Week is also heard on ESPN Radio. Our advertising packages start for as little as $50 per week. Expand your brand with the Varsity Sports Network.
Let's get back to living and let White as Snow Cleaning and More help you along the way. White as Snow Cleaning and More is committed to a higher standard of clean. Our staff is both professional and dependable. Whether it's residential or commercial, no job is too big nor too small. Call us for a free estimate, 850-866-2031. White as Snow Cleaning and More is committed to a higher standard of clean so you can get back to living.
Back here from the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week. Kickoff on the way. It's Chiles, and it is JP2 here on the return. A full head of steam over on the far sideline, the 40, the 45, and dropped just before midfield. But a fierce return by Makari Vickers, the young sophomore, the big rip over on the far side.
Yeah, he showed a whole bunch of speed on that and had a caravan of blockers in front of him. And got good field position for the Panthers. As the ball is going to be marked right outside the 50-yard line. In their own territory, set it up at about the 48.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Get it going. So beautiful opportunity for JP2 to answer here, Tony. Of course, right out by midfield, down by a full eight. Will be interesting to see what JP2 calls it up here. And if they get down there, maybe going for two. Of course, as always, Tony, I'm getting ahead of myself. So I'll dial it back. But John Paul II, we've seen a heavy run going here so far. We've seen Jefferson do some damage. Of course, we've seen some quick hitters out to Tyrion Arnold. A little bit of everything sprinkled in here. Yet to see Hughes really on any design quarterback runs here, Tony, with any consistency. Of course, we know a very good dual threat quarterback is the freshman. Well, single back set under center. Here comes the motion from the wide out. Maybe a little too early from one of these linemen going here. Maybe on the offense.
It's going to be a delay of gain called against the Panthers. And that's going to bring them back to about the 40, seems like about the 43-yard line.
And so we saw the play clock ticking down. And so maybe it was false start. Maybe it was delay of game. It's like, you know, the clock gets down to zero, Tony. So the offensive line, they're going regardless. You know?
You might as well.
So down to first down and 15 now as they're backed up. Of course, we're in quarter number two here, 3:22 on the north side. Here, Chiles and JP2, the hometown Timberwolves, of course, with the eight-point advantage here in quarter number two. And giving it to the outside. Once again, a little hesitation. Lowers the shoulder.
Ooh.
And a mean rush by Jaden Jefferson. And the junior dropping the boom, Tony.
My goodness.
He's not scared of contact.
No, he's not scared of contact, and he's going to pick up a first down or close to it. Oh, you know what? That 5-yard mark off is what really messed him up. So it's going to bring up a second down and about 8 yards to go for the first down as the ball is going to be marked right outside the 50-yard line. He lowered the boom on that one.
Yes,
we
sir.
Heard it from up here in the press box.
No doubt about it. No doubt about it. So under center once again is Hughes, wide receiver to each side. Looks like Jefferson, the tailback, ball in the 50-yard line. Motion once again. They'll fake the reverse. And here comes some trouble trying to get outside the pocket. Hughes,
oh, my God.
And the old turf monster gets him way back at the 34-yard line. It's going to be about a loss of 14 on the play, Tony.
Yeah, man. Well, he was trying to get out that pocket, but he had a big rush coming in on him and just wasn't able to escape before that turf monster got him. And he was just went down.
He had nowhere to go and trying to just buy himself some time. And
well, when you get outside the pocket like that, you're just supposed to throw the ball away, but I don't think he had time to do that.
Yep, a lot of pressure. He's looking for an error, try to avoid the grounding. Really tough scenario for the young man. So now the ball back at the 35-yard line. They have to get to the 42 of Chiles in order to move the chains here, Tony. It's going to be about 23 yards to go. And I think Coach Hill needs a little more time to talk about this one.
He's going to call a timeout on this one.
So, Tony, while we have the opportunity, we will jump out and, as we like to call it, go around the bend.
Yeah, man, might as well.
On in the area. Score update down in Crawfordville. 3-0, the Wakulla War Eagles leading the Columbia Tigers. Down to Gene Cox Stadium, a couple of scores, one each way. Lincoln leading Gobby 14-6. Trucking on down to Perry, Florida. Madison County with an 8-0 lead. Still in the first half. Monroe Day all over Bronson. 35-0, Tony.
That's still in the first half.
And so we're moving down. No score updates otherwise. We'll try to get you updated. Of course, if you happen to be at one of those games or have an inside track on a scoring update, feel free to message us on social media there. Of course, at VSN Tallahassee on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Tony, and we'll try to plug those through as we see fit. But of course, thanks for tuning in here, whether you're a WTSM 979 ESPN Radio or watching us at varsitysportsnetwork.org. Under center, Hughes goes again, play action, slips on the turf. Here comes the pressure. He's going to throw it deep over on the far side. Almost completed.
Yeah.
They're hounding him on defense over on the far side. I believe it was Trip Reagan's.
Well, there was a lot
15.
Of there was a lot of hand battling out there, but no call. And, you know, perfectly well-played ball by the defense. And that ball falls incomplete.
Intended for Makari Vickers. And my mistake, it looks like the pass breakup was number 16, Jace Bartusek. But a nice play there. Tony, as a DB, do you like the no call? Because we saw a little jostling either way there.
Yeah, it was just a good no call on that particular play.
So it's going to set up fourth down here, looking for JP2 to punt it away. Big Isaiah Bedell off to give it, Big Antonio Jones off to give it a blast. Number 55 of the St. John Paul II Panthers. Five more yards in reverse after the false start, though, Tony.
Yeah, well, we see that the Panthers are committing a lot of little mental errors right now, and that is what is keeping them not progressing as they should, because they had a good kickoff return, but they went backwards from that point.
A good opening drive to start as well. Mm-hmm. Looks like another penalty flag.
So we've had about 10 penalties in the last 1 minute. Another false start on the part of JP2.
Yeah, we were cruising probably about the first 22 minutes.
Yeah.
Or no, probably about the first 20 minutes of this ball game, Tony. And then kind of come into a halt, some stoppages, some incompletes, some penalties. And
water breaks.
That'll draw things out a little bit. Of course, always got to keep the young men hydrated here.
Not dehydrated.
Yeah, you don't want to keep them dehydrated. Yeah.
You want to keep them hydrated, man.
Goodness. So this one is going to be about a 33-yard conversion here on fourth down. The boot, and it is a monster one.
And that's
Herring backed all the way up and immediately wrapped up and gets some reinforcements back at the 28-yard line.
Yeah.
But a great punt by Jones. And how about the Gunners getting down there, Tony?
Yeah, well, I tell you
what. Mike Bergstrom, the big senior.
Yeah, but I tell you what, I believe that this is going to be a rough in the kicker. It's going to give JP2 an automatic first down. Yeah, roughing the kicker is going to be an automatic first down. JP2 has new life.
Yeah, so how about that, Tony? I mean, this is kind of one of the instances you kind of put a bookmark in. We had a couple of them last night, some small conversions. But, I mean, the first down, able to get the first down here now at the 40-yard line. But this will be an interesting play to watch, Tony, because a potentially 14-point swing in the motion here, and this will be the catalyst. So the little shotgun looks something different for Hughes. Give him a little more time. Slant route. Samaj James on the reception. He's able to be dropped out here at the perimeter.
I'm not sure if they're going to call that a completion or not. It doesn't seem like he held the ball long enough. But had he been able to hold that ball and elude that, he would have. That would have been 6 points.
Yeah, so that was a good pickup. They're going to rule it a catch.
Well, they're giving him a first down.
So, yeah, 14-yard reception.
Yeah, they're going to give him
a catch. Because he had it on the slant, and then he got knocked down. Then the ball came out. But so first look we've seen from James on the reception, and he's kind of a dynamite combo. Watch this. It's a James Arnold stack over here on the right side of this formation. Hughes out of the shotgun. He's been under center for most of the night, but I like the change up here. Give the young man a little more time. Hand off to Jefferson. Gets him going north-south. Shakes out of one. Shakes off two. 10 yards and then some. A beautiful rush by Jefferson. Pick up 12.
Yeah, 1:38 left in this game, this first half anyway, and the Panthers are on the move.
Absolutely.
Ball is going to be marked at about the 34-yard line.
And of course,
first and 10 from that point.
Hurry up offense. 89 seconds to go in the half right now. So JP Deuce showing a little tempo. I like it. Keep the same personnel on the field. They're going to flip the wide receivers. Two to the left now, one to the right. Hughes getting out of the shotgun. Hitter out of the perimeter. It's James again. Shakes off the first tackle. Shakes off the second. He's going down the sideline. He's inside the 15. Ran about the 11, 12-yard line. And once again, it's Hughes and James syncing up down into the red zone now. For JP2.
And more importantly, it stops the clock because James was just too big, too strong on that particular play, shaking off any of those little hand tackles. You can't arm tackle this guy. You've got to lay some pads on him.
Absolutely. And Samaj James, all of 6'2", Tony.
Yeah.
It'd be interesting to see. Maybe they give him a little jump ball in the corner if they have some time. But you got to watch Tyrion Arnold in the slot out here to the left side. Also in the perimeter is Makari Vickers out there to the left. Three wide receiver look. Ball skipped into Hughes. He's going to buy some time. Throws it up into the end zone to
touchdown.
Vickers. Does he get the feet down? He does. A beautiful catch. Hughes able to improvise and put it in. Cash in the touchdown there as he's able to punch it through and go forward for the touchdown here. And he's able to get this one into the end zone for 6.
Going to be a touchdown on the part of man, that was just an excellent play on the part of the quarterback for JP2 as he was able to and they're going to go for the 2-point conversion.
Absolutely. So we were talking about it, Tony, said we were getting a little ahead of ourselves, but here we go. Things playing out. It's going to be Jefferson to the left. And it's going to be a beautiful fake. And Hughes plays it off beautifully. Jefferson will stroll on into the end zone, Tony, and we'll tie this ball game up at 14 apiece.
Wow, I tell you what, this is turning out to be a really good game. 55 seconds left in the first half. We're all tied up on the north side of Tallahassee. Well, you know what, man, we've got to talk about this JP2, in fact, because, you know, a couple of years ago, they didn't really have enough players on the team, you know? They had enough players, but they didn't have enough a limited amount of players.
Right, absolutely, Tony. They
and
actually
each
had
year
to
they've
forfeit,
been building.
Forfeit 2 years ago, the final, I believe it was five or six football games because they did not have enough personnel due to injuries and a couple other concerns around the program. And so they were wondering if they would even have a football program, but Coach Hill has really revitalized it, changed the entire outlook of everything here around this JP2 program. But here comes Wilcher, the quarterback, wants to set himself up with some good field position and does. A beautiful return out to the 33.
Well, I tell you what, Wilshire is one of those dynamic players, and he still has a lot of time left and some playmakers to help him out. 54 seconds left in this first half, and it ain't over yet, Juke. Ball is going to be marked at about the 30, looks like at the 30-yard line, and that's where the Timberwolves are going to start from that point.
So here we go, kickoff on the turf. It was a skimmer, Tony. Of course, the ball has been very difficult to handle. Of course, a little bit of dampness is kind of sitting on the turf right now. So if you see the players slipping or some tough ball handling that we've seen out here this evening, that is due to these wet conditions. It's going to be play action. Wilcher bootleg to the left for the righty. He's just going to take off and run. Gets to the out of bounds, but a good pickup over here on the near side. Skips out about the 38, but an 8-yard pickup.
Yep. And more importantly, it stops the clock with 44 seconds left in the first half. And believe me, they are not content to go into this game with a tie. I'm sure that the Timberwolves want to pick up some, put some more points on the board.
Absolutely. Of course, you've got an offense that's shown on the other side with some dynamic playmakers. Points when the opportunity to keep that aggressive mindset going forward. Ball on the left hash mark, 38-yard line is where we have the ball. Of course, Chiles still in their own territory. Only need to get to the 40, but the clock is more of a concern than the down mark. A massive hit on the quarterback as he gets rid of the ball. Beautiful pressure coming in from the next level for JP2.
And it looks like Wilshire is going to be down on the turf, man. He's writhing in pain.
Delvion Allison, clean hit, Tony, just right at the midsection. The quarterback hanging tough, delivers the throw. And, of course, seems to be injured on the list, the play here, Tony. So while we have the opportunity, we're going to run a quick break here, of course, from our Stoppage of Play sponsors. Tony, of course, seeing my man, as they say, is believing, Tony. Yep. Of course, that's why you need to see what's happening with Tall Timber Photography. Tall Timber cares about what's in front of the camera, and that's you. That's why they have personalized consultations in every edit done by hand, so they're as unique as you are, my man. No templates, no pre-made designs, or awkward poses.
None of that.
Family-owned and operated right here in Tallahassee, focused on capturing the perfect moment that'll be as timeless as it is today, 60 years from now, with next-level shooting experience from the University of Miami and University of North Florida, Tall Timbers brings the big leagues to your capture-worthy moments, whether it's high school, youth leagues, weddings, engagements. Tony, maternity shoots, they do it all, my man. Check them out at talltimber.com or visit their stunning, and I mean, this is no hyperbole, Tony. They've got an absolutely gorgeous social media page, got some offers going on right now. At Tall Timber Photo, at Tall Timber Sports on Facebook and Instagram. Gorgeous photographs, man. Absolutely beautiful stuff. So check them out if you're looking for any kind of deal. They have a little sports package going on right now to highlight your favorite student athlete. But like we said, they do it all. Short gain out of the Wildcat. Jalen Herring diving forward. So it's going to be fourth down and about two. With about 30 seconds to go, and it looks like Coach Ed Hale calls a timeout. He says, we want this ball one more time before the half.
Yeah, well, it's going to be a fourth down, so why not?
31 seconds left in the half.
Yeah, 31 seconds is a long time, man, especially when you have some playmakers like we've seen tonight.
Absolutely, and that's what I liked about that previous drive, Tony. Of course, the tempo and the time left on the clock forced the issue, but we saw Samaj Shames get involved, and then we also saw, of course, the running back sprinkled in there. Mm-hmm. We saw Hughes use a little bit more of his dual threat abilities, outside the pocket, kind of playing to their strengths. So I think the hurry-up offense, two-minute drill, suited them, Tony. And we saw them come out successful with an eight-point touchdown drive and able to tie this up here at 14-14. This is a 2A versus 7A school right now here, Tony. Yeah,
that's right.
Panthers playing in the big leagues right now.
Yeah, they are. And you know what, man? Tremaine Hughes is only a freshman. Let's remember that. But this guy has seven touchdowns already this season, five passing and two rushing. So he's capable of doing that, and he's only in ninth grade. And as you say, it's unbelievable. He was going to Cobb Middle School last year.
Yeah, just last year. You think about it, Tony. I mean, he was captaining the Purple Panthers down there at Cobb, and now he's up here at the high school level, and he's doing just as well, if not better, Tony.
Yeah.
Of course, the tutelage from Coach Hill coming through the youth ranks of Tallahassee, well-known. Of course, Tremaine's father also involved on that big state or national championship youth football team, so they know how to develop young talent, Tony.
Mm-hmm. That's
and
right.
It's really paying off for him in a school where you have to utilize all the grades because you don't have the bigger pool of players that you have in these public schools out here.
That's right. There's going to be a flag on the play.
Pre-snap penalty here that looks like they're going to tag it up on the defense, which would be an automatic first down.
Yeah, it is going to be a mark off against the Panthers, and they are just continuing to commit these little mental errors that, but they're still in this ball game. So it's 14-14 with 39 seconds left in the game.
And that's an interesting change of pace, Tony. So of course on the third down, Wiltshire was injured, and so JP2 calling a timeout in order to stop the clock.
Get the ball back.
On second down, but he's stopped on third down. So now Wiltshire's back into the ballgame. He's able to make the hard count, which gets them the first down. Tony, had they let that play ride out, they might not have put Wiltshire back into the ballgame. So just an interesting kind of cat and mouse, these little nuances, Tony.
That's right.
But like we said, Wiltshire showing some composure. How often do you see a sophomore get him with the hard count there, Tony?
Yeah, man. Well, he's been doing it all night. I think I've seen at least twice so far tonight where he's showing a lot of maturity, and he's only in 10th grade as well.
So there you go, second down. 29.6 seconds to go here in the second quarter of action from Chiles High School. Like we said, 9-14 apiece in the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week simulcast on WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio, Tony.
That's right.
So we're going to have another stoppage of play.
My goodness.
And so it's a timeout. We're going to jump out for a quick commercial break, Tony. What you say we do a little radio business here? Come back on the other side.
Welcome to Big Core. This is Big Core. I would like for everybody to come out to my restaurant, come enjoy my country cooking in the city of Tallahassee. I'm a country boy and coming to the big city to give y'all great food, great atmosphere, great staff, great service, great everything. On game days, birthdays, parties, any days that y'all want it, I got it. I'm gonna put all the other restaurant chains to shame. I specialize in fried chicken, best fried chicken you will ever eat in your whole life. I promise you that. Come on down to Big Course Country Cooking, 1812 on South Monroe, walking distance from FAMU. I got the food, everything ready for you. 850-383-8227.
You're looking for a great opportunity to expand your brand? Here's your chance of a lifetime. The Varsity Sports Network has all kinds of advertising packages to fit your budget. The Varsity Sports Network, 1 million viewers, 150,000 views per month. And our Friday Night Football Game of the Week is also heard on ESPN Radio. Our advertising packages start for as little as $50 per week. Expand your brand with the Varsity Sports Network.
Northside battle right now, Chiles and St. John Paul II here, 26.2 to go here in the opening half of action. And this is a good contest, Tony. We thought it'd be a close one, and we're getting what we wanted, my man.
There you go.
So, of course, getting ready to continue to get forward here. This one's going deep, and it's intercepted. JP2, it's Tyrion Arnold. Watch out when he's in the open field. He's going to pick up some blocks. He's trying to stretch this one out to the far side, and he skips out of bounds about the 45-yard line, Tony. And that's...
And it's going to be a penalty. That's going to be a penalty on Chiles. That's going to put another 15 yards added on to that interception, to the end of that interception. And Arnold was able to run... run that ball into Chiles territory, stepped out of bounds at about the 45-yard line. I think they're going to mark off another 15 yards on this play.
Oh, man. It'll be interesting to see whether it's offsetting or it's solely on Chiles, Tony.
Dead ball foul, personal foul against both teams. It's going to be offsetting.
So they'll break them even there.
They'll break them even.
But, of course, it looked like a miscommunication. And, of course, Terrion Arnold taking advantage, Tony. We knew it was always going to be a matter of time before he gets involved. So here you go, your big two DBs. Samaj James on the first drive. And then here right before halftime, Terrion Arnold each with an interception. It's going to give St. John Paul II another chance.
Yeah, 15 seconds left in this first half.
You know, maybe two plays left here, Tony. If you can pick up about 15 yards, I think you got a real chance to chuck this one into the end zone. You got 6'2", Samaj James. Maybe try to give him a jump ball if you can get down there. First down and 10, rolling for JP2. Hughes, he's going to go over the middle. Mm-hmm. And a little high for his intended receiver.
Yeah.
Trying to hook up with Jaden Walden, the fellow freshman. Tony.
Yeah, well, Jaden just could not get any separation in that backfield. And that ball was just smartly overthrown. 9.9 seconds left. And the Panthers still have one more shot at it.
Absolutely.
Maybe two.
So, yeah, if it's by the sideline, I think they definitely have another one, Tony. I don't think they'll be able to get up on it if they hit the first down. Of course, clock will stop as they move the chain. Shotgun look, four wide receivers. One tailback, sidecar right. Jefferson will stay in. Hughes going to go downtown. He's looking for Vickers again, and he breaks free. And JP2, monster touchdown, 47 yards.
Vickers catches
in another one. The first one was a toe tap and touchdown.
Yeah.
This one, he straddles the sideline.
Yes, man.
And
that
the
was
away section is going off, Tony.
That was absolutely beautiful. He dropped that dime in the bucket, man. Right into the end zone. My. What a way to end the first half. 2.9 seconds left in this first half of football, and the Panthers have taken themselves they've taken themselves a 20-14 lead.
Absolutely.
With the point after attempt coming up.
So, Tony, we got an early nominee with Makari Vickers here for our real-life radio player of the game.
Absolutely.
This one is up and good.
Conversion. No good.
No success there, but it's going to stay at a six-point advantage here. Still 2.9 seconds to go. Only 7 seconds. He went down the sideline so fast, Tony. It only took 7 seconds to complete that play.
Yeah, that's right, because there were 9.9 seconds. There were 9.9 seconds, and he heaved that ball. That was a perfect dime, about 40 yards in the air.
Yes, sir. No doubt about it, my man. And so we know Hughes has got an arm now, Tony. Yeah. Something we hadn't really seen him go deep. We've seen him go to the perimeter a couple times.
Right.
But absolute gorgeous throw.
And he's got the playmakers to stretch the field as well.
Absolutely, man. And this is going to be a man to watch. We talk about the young guys out here.
Freshman, man.
Freshman.
Freshman.
Tremaine Hughes.
Yeah, that was pretty much
as well, Tony.
Yeah, it was pretty much unheard of back in the ancient days when I went to high school. Freshmen were on the freshman team.
Of course, a small high school, Tony.
Yeah,
said, all hands on deck, man.
That's right. The same way with someone like a FAMU High. So here comes the kick. It's going to be caught and fair caught at about the 34-yard line, and that's where Chiles is going to take over. First and 10 with 2.9 seconds left in this first half of football. Well, it looks like they're going to have JP2 kick it over. 2.9 seconds left in the game. First half of this football game, I should say. St. John Paul with a 20-14 lead over the Timberwolves. And as you were saying before, Juke, this is a 2A school going against a 7A school. And you're not expecting this to happen.
Hey, absolutely. They're playing big time here, Tony. Of course, they've been playing up in classification. Played a big North Bay Haven 4-5A school earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Back at it here. That's one thing Coach Hill said. He said, we'll go play anybody, anywhere. They took a road trip down to Lakeland early in the season. First week, Tony.
Yeah.
You're traveling down to Lakeland. That's about a five-hour drive.
Well, that
was
a five-hour drive, and it was a 50-0 whipping on them. Who?
But it woke them up, Tony. They came back with three straight victories, three straight shutouts by the defense. Ball pick up to the five-yard line. Herring slips on the turf, and he's going to be wrapped up and slung down right about the 10. And that is how we will get to halftime here, Tony. A fierce bring down and a wild way. We had a very exciting second quarter of action going forward here, Tony.
Yeah, that last 22 seconds lasted for about 10 or 15 minutes, but it was all worth it for St. John Paul II. The Panthers were able to drop a dime and put 6 points on the board and take the lead with a 20-14 lead here at halftime.
Absolutely. So we're going to jump out for some commercials. We'll come back, give you a recap on some area scores and, of course, the first half of action. And hopefully we'll be ready to go by kickoff right then. Andrew Duke, Tony Williams, Walter Weaver, Deanna Denoso here on the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week. Come right on back.
Welcome to Big Core. This is Big Core. I would like for everybody to come out to my restaurant, come enjoy my country cooking in the city of Tallahassee. I'm a country boy and coming to the big city to give y'all great food, great atmosphere, great staff, great service, great everything. On game days, birthdays, parties, any days that y'all want it, I got it. I'm gonna put all the other restaurant chains to shame. I specialize in fried chicken, best fried chicken you will ever eat in your whole life. I promise you that. Come on down to Big Course Country Cooking, 1812 on South Monroe, walking distance from FAMU. I got the food, everything ready for you. 850-383-8227.
Let's get back to living and let Whitest Snow Cleaning and More help you along the way. Whitest Snow Cleaning and More is committed to a higher standard of clean. Our staff is both professional and dependable. Whether it's residential or commercial, no job is too big nor too small. Call us for a free estimate, 850-866-2031. Whitest Snow Cleaning and More is committed to a higher standard of clean so you can get back to living.
Welcome to Big Core. This is Big Core. I would like for everybody to come out to my restaurant, come enjoy my country cooking in the city of Tallahassee. I'm a country boy and coming to the big city to give y'all great food, great atmosphere, great staff, great service, great everything. On game days, birthdays, parties, any days that y'all want it, I got it. I'm gonna put all the other restaurant chains to shame. I specialize in fried chicken, best fried chicken you will ever eat in your whole life. I promise you that. Come on down to Big Course Country Cooking, 1812 on South Monroe, walking distance from FAMU. I got the food, everything ready for you. 850-383-8227.
You're looking for a great opportunity to expand your brand? Here's your chance of a lifetime. The Varsity Sports Network has all kinds of advertising packages to fit your budget. The Varsity Sports Network, 1 million viewers, 150,000 views per month. And our Friday Night Football Game of the Week is also heard on ESPN Radio. Our advertising packages start for as little as $50 per week. Expand your brand with the Varsity Sports Network.
Hey, and welcome back to the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week here on WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio. Of course, we are at the halftime break we have going on right now, Tony. And it has been a fun one so far going. Of course, we've seen both sides have a phenomenal performance so far out here as far as the scoring the football. Of course, Tony, great effort for both teams, like we said, Tony. But what's the biggest thing, I guess, is sticking out to you so far?
I tell you what, Ju, what I've been really been impressed with is the play of the freshman quarterback, Mr. Hughes. Hughes has just been phenomenal, completing over 100 yards passing so far and getting the ball into the hands of his playmakers. He's looking like he has a whole lot of poise out there. And then you got to remember that the stars are shining for St. Paul John II as well. As Terry and Arnold has gotten into the groove of things, he's rushed for over at least, and this is all unofficial now, but he's rushed for over 40 yards, I'm sure, so far this game. Jalen Jefferson has been doing, has been the workhorse for St. John Paul. And everyone is just, you know, just on their game, man. These guys have not been afraid to play against this big 7A team that we call the Chiles Timberwolves. So that's what I've been seeing so far, man.
I feel like I'm awaiting a shuttle launch, Tony. I feel like we got the countdown, and nothing really happened here.
So here we go.
But it looks like we're off and rolling. Finally, we have a monster kick worth the wait, Tony.
Yeah.
All the way to the back half of the end zone. A good little piece of leg there from Mike Smith, who is a young man who's getting some good little spotlights here, Tony,
yeah.
Is the kicker.
Well, Smith definitely did not want to see Arnold R. Jefferson running that ball back out of the end zone. So he just simply put it away.
Absolutely. Quickly becoming a one of the higher recruits here in the class of 2023, Tony. A blossoming star here on the special teams for Chiles Timberwolves. You never underestimate special teams, Tony.
No.
I think, of course, the renowned coach Frank Beamer reminds us all of that, Tony. Of course, playing or coaching for Virginia Tech.
Most definitely.
Games can be won and lost on the special teams, my man. So here we go, third quarter of action, getting ready to rock and roll. Jermaine Hughes, little motion from Samaj James. He's going to come over to the bunch formation. The whole side over there on the open side is wide open. Jefferson with a whole bunch of real estate puts his foot in the ground, cuts it back. About a 5-yard pickup. Tony, you knew it was going to that right side because there was no one over there after the motion from James coming near side.
Yeah, well, he was just able to pick up about 5 yards, and that was an excellent tackle on the part of the linebackers to come up and stop that play because it could have gone for a long, long way. But as it stands, it picks up 5 yards, brings up a 2nd and 5. Ball is going to be marked at the 25-yard line for St. John Paul II Panthers.
Absolutely, as they get ready to reload here and break the huddle.
Two receivers set for Hughes. One back, and here comes the snap. He's going to hand it off to his running back, and he's going to break out to the left-hand side. He's going to have some room. He's going to get out of bounds. He's still on his feet, and he's going to be bumped out of bounds at about the 42-yard line. That's Arnold, and he picks up about a good 15, 16 yards on that play. So a good start for the Panthers as they are continuing to repeat where they left off, moving the ball. Ball is going to be marked right at the 41-yard line. It's going to be a 1st and 10 from that point for the Panthers. Hughes has his team huddled up. 7 seconds left on the play clock, so he's going to have to hurry up on this particular play. One, and he gets it off in time. He's going to give it right up the middle. He's going to pass that ball to his receiver, and it's going to be...
Going to need a ruling on that. Tony, we'll let you be the judge. Quick
well, it looks like he got his hands under the ball, and they're going to say it's going to be... I'm not sure what they're going to call. It looks like they're going to say it's completed.
So we're looking on the replay, Tony. That looks like a catch. James does get underneath of it. I think that's a catch there for the big reception, and it's a good play by Hughes, just throwing off of his back foot.
Yeah, he was.
Able to sail it up. And James, who was running about a 10-yard curl, Tony, able to dive back against the grain here, or maybe about a 12-yarder, and get underneath of it. But that is a legitimate catch. Great effort there by Samaj James.
It's going to be a first down. Looks like a 2nd and 1.
Very short, yeah. Single back set going here under center. Hughes, quick hitter out to the perimeter. Hits his man Vickers. Trying to spin out of the first tackle and does. Resets, makes another man miss. First down and then some. Still going, and he flips over the 40. Move the chains for JP2. And, man, Vickers is an absolute beast. A 6'2 sophomore. Tony, I don't know if he was a star ahead of time. And but if he was, I'm just becoming aware of it. And maybe that's on me, Tony.
Yeah.
Because Vickers is a beast out here on the perimeter.
Yeah, Makari Vickers, man, wide receiver. He's only a sophomore, 6'2", 181 pounds. And I tell you what, he's been a workhorse as well. These guys have a lot of weapons at their disposal.
Vickers, of course, has the most touchdowns in this game. 2 touchdown receptions, more than any other player, either team. So James split out over the far side. Vickers out here to the left. Gives to Jefferson. That's a north-south kind of guy. Spins out of the first would-be tackle. But a sea of Chiles defenders able to make the drop. Good team tackle there. I mean, whoever you want. I'm going to give Octavius Williams a shout-out there, Tony. There are about four Timberwolves. The pack.
Yeah.
Submerging on the Panthers there.
Yeah, wolf pack, a whole wolf pack. He picks up 2 yards. It's going to bring up a second down and eight. Ball is going to be inside of Chiles territory. At the, looks like about the 37-yard line. So the Panthers are continuing to move. The second down and eight. Hughes going under center. Single back set. And he's going to hand it off. He's going to pass the ball right into the flat, and it's going to be completed over to Arnold, or Vickers, it looks like. And Vickers is going to struggle for about, looks like for about 6 yards.
There's a Kevin Brown.
Kevin Brown.
The six and the eight, very hard to tell over there on the far side with the narrow angle that we have.
Yeah, yes, exactly true. And plus my eyes are getting older. And the binoculars are not working.
No. Nope. Did they break? We dropped them. We threw them off the bleachers one too many times, Tony.
One too many times.
Man, I was hoping it would never catch up with us, but.
Well, it does.
A firsthand lesson, Tony, that all actions have consequences, whether they be positive or negative.
That's correct.
Motion from Smajims. We saw this last time this formation was run. It was a pitch out to the far side. This time they're coming near side. Jefferson picks up a block, trying to tackle him in the backfield, but he escapes, Tony.
Yeah, he did.
Able to get back to the line of scrimmage and maybe a couple yards, but a penalty flag on the field.
It's going to be holding against JP2.
So that was going to be a spot of the foul.
Yeah, that was a very late flag. But instead of it being a third and five, it's probably going to be about a third and, they'll call it about a third and 15.
Yeah, depending on where the penalty flag came about, because there are a number of layers of blocking, Tony. Of course, the wide receivers back here, and then some of the other linemen coming on the end around, but they're going to back it up, long story short, to the 48-yard line.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be about 20 yards to get a first down.
Yeah, they're going to need to get all the way to the 29. Of course, ball dead center of the field here. 8:26 in the third quarter of action here in the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week. Andrew Jupe, Tony Williams, Daniela Denoso, Walter Weaver bringing you the action here this evening from the north side. Chiles Timberwolves and the St. John Paul II Panthers. Hughes stepping up in the pocket. Oh, and it's intercepted. Going back the other way. Man on the takeaway is Christian Corbett, weaving through traffic back into JP2 territory. And that's the takeaway Chiles needed, Tony. A little pick-me-up here for the home side.
Yeah, that was an ill-advised pass on the part of Hughes. He was in double coverage as he tried to hit his receiver out in the flat and just had no chance to complete that pass.
May not have seen him, Tony. It was a great disguise in the second half. Corbett was kind of hanging out in the flat there. And then once he saw Hughes was doing it, he kind of backed up and able to land the takeaway. I think that was just a good defensive play, able to jump in front of that one. But, of course, something that the young freshman is going to look at in film class this
week. That's right.
And that's something he's going to be looking for here going forward. So, like you said, Tony, a growing moment for the freshman. But let's not take away Corbett. Beautiful read on the coverage there.
Absolutely.
So here we go, set him up here, ball from the 48. Herring, get a little open space, nice little rip for him, 5 or 6 yards for the senior, surging forward in the middle of the field. So a nice little rush there, getting it rolling for the Timberwolves.
That's the Timberwolf fan base is cranking up and ready to rock somebody.
There you go.
Brings up a second down with about 6 yards to go. The ball is going to be inside of St. John Paul territory. At about the 44-yard line.
Officially halftime, Gene Cox Stadium. Lincoln 17, got me 14. A tight one still going down there. Cutting back against the grain. Herring's going to muscle out about 3 more yards.
That's going to make it a little bit more manageable. Third down and save. We'll call it about 2 or 3 yards, a long 3 yards to go for the Timberwolves to pick up that first down. Ball is marked at the 41-yard line of St. John Paul II Panthers.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, of course, needing to get to the 38. Ball favoring the right side of the field. Of course, Chiles going left to right. I guess it's kind of a west to east pseudo-geographically. Max Protect, look, running back each side. Wiltshire, give his dude Herring down the hash marks inside the 30. Good tackle at the second level by Leon Washington Jr.
Yeah, Leon.
But move the chains for the Timberwolves.
Yeah,
it's
Leon.
Jalen Herring.
Yeah, yeah, that's Herring on the carry, but Leon Washington was hanging on for dear life. And if he hadn't been able to hang on, man, that could have been 6 points easily.
I'm liking this dual back threat, though. Gives him a little more deception here, Tony. And, of course, a lead blocker, bringing Christian Gallette into the backfield, sidecar right, and, of course, Herring sidecar left. And if they elect to pass, it's a nice little Max Protect look. They give it to Herring.
Fumble.
Football's on the ground, down around the hash marks inside the 20-yard line. Is the knee down or is it out, Tony?
That ball was out. I'm not sure if I think that Chiles was able to recover the fumble, though. But that ball was definitely out.
So, of course, we get back to replay. We just see the dog pile there, Tony.
Covered by the Timberwolves.
And yep. So the Timberwolves able to recover the fumble, and the ball actually moves forward.
Yeah, it did.
And so it looks like they'll be close, if not a first down, Tony.
Yeah, that ball is going to be marked right about the 21-yard line. Looks like there's going to be a timeout called on the part of St. John Paul.
And so there, sometimes, what's the old adage, Tony? Sometimes it's better be lucky than good.
Yeah, man.
A nice little bounce there for the Timberwolves.
Yeah, it was.
So let's see how Chiles answers here. As we see, they break the huddle, get things rocking and rolling. So they're going to go with that Max Protect look that we've been liking here, Tony.
Mm-hmm.
Running back to either side. This time, of course, they're going to switch where the running backs are. Gallette will go over sidecar left. Herring will be to the right. One wide receiver spread way out to the left-hand side. Give it to Herring going towards the center, surging through.
Wow.
And the linebacker able to truck on through is Devin Robinson, the senior DB, shooting right down the gap. Beautiful tackle for a loss there.
Yeah, it's going to be a loss of about 4 yards on the play. It's going to bring up a second down. The ball is going to be marked all the way back to about the 19, let's call it the 20-yard line, about the 19-yard line. We'll call it the 19-yard line.
And you can see in spurts these DBs, when they get flying downhill, Tony, they are clean tacklers. And that's one thing we've seen.
Yeah, clean tackle.
Maybe that's what the teams have been working on the offseason, Tony, because I feel like in years past, you know, we've had some rough spurts of tackling. But, I mean, we saw the game last night between Rickards and Florida High. Beautiful tackling. And that game's seen some good tackling out here as well. And this one's going to be wrapped up right about the 13-yard line. Herring twisting and turning again, Tony. About six more yards for him.
Yeah, he's going to get the ball all the way down to about the, looks like about the 13-yard line.
So, of course, they need to get down to about the 6 to move the chain. So it's still about 3rd down 7, of course, after the penalty yardage being paid off here. It's still a crucial situation, and you got to watch, Tony, not a lot of deep stuff available here. You got to think that Arnold, the lone deep guy, is going to be jumping these short routes. Here comes the double. Oh, they fake the double handoff. Herring keeps it, but a great open field tackle again, and it's Tyrion Arnold coming up from the second level to make the drop. 4th down.
Yeah, Arnold has really been busy, man. I tell you, this guy has been everywhere. And, of course, as we know, he came into tonight's.
And coach says we are going for it. So they line up there. We can see the line getting set up. And here Wiltshire, the give, and they're going to straight up the middle, need to get to the 6. It's going to depend on the spot.
I'm not sure if he got it.
Looks like about a yard short, according to the side judge on the far side.
Yeah, that's going to be a turnover on downs.
So big defensive stand, gets the JP2 sideline pump. Look at the coaching staff and the players over there.
Well, that was an excellent stand for JP2 because they really had the ball driving fearlessly into the end zone when they threw the interception. So luckily for them, the defense was able to stand up and turn this ball over on downs.
So 3:39 to go here in the third quarter of action. Ball's going to be marked just shy of the 8-yard line. JP2 backed up deep in their own end. They're going from right to left. Of course, that's about east to west geographically, roughly. Of course, in the navy blue helmets, navy blue tops, white pants with the gold trim. Some nice-looking uniforms. Of course, Chiles with the Alabama look, all white. with the maroon helmets and the white numbers on top there. Good play action over the middle. It's a big-time reception.
It was.
Big target, Samaj James.
Yeah.
12 more yards, move the chains.
Yeah, that was 12 more yards, move the chains, and that was excellent stand-in for Hughes as he just looked real poised. I'm just finding it so hard to believe that this guy is still a freshman. He's poised.
Absolutely, man.
And he shot that ball right in through the center and completed it for the first down.
Absolutely. Fired it in there real nice. So, of course, going under center again, that single back set, two wides, one to each side that they love. Tony, a lot of guys on the line. Quick hitter. Watch out for Arnold here on the perimeter. Makes the first man miss. Second man, too. Oh, next level. Here he goes. Little hesitation out to the 40. And, man, it's seemingly hanging on the balance of him breaking one almost every single play. Tony, pick up of about 17. And that was just a screen pass at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, he had to do that all by his lonesome, and he did it too. Picked up 17 yards. That ball is going to be moved all the way up to the 40-yard line, or we'll call it the 39-yard line. And that's where JP2 is going to take over. First down.
It's a beautiful pickup by Terry Arnold. Continue to add some more to the highlight reel. Once again, single back set under center. This time they're going to split out one tight end to turn into a wide receiver. Two on the far side. One here near side is Makari Vickers. Of course, Hughes under center. Give to Jefferson. He's going to get outside. Needs a block from his wideout. Gets it. And the young running back able to pick up about 10 on the rush.
Yeah, Jefferson, of course, picked up about 9 yards on that rush. It's going to bring up a second down and less than 1 yard to go. Jefferson, of course, came into tonight's game with 4 rushing touchdowns already. So this guy is also a beast for JP2.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And, of course, he had the first touchdown of the game, Tony. So it's a season tally. Mark it up to 5. And we're about as short as a second down. You can get, what do we call it, maybe a foot, Tony?
Yeah, and that's what I say. We call that the nose of the football.
There you go. Because usually in high school, they're rounding up or rounded down, Tony. So very rarely do you see it truly get under a yard. Oh, here comes the bootleg. Chiles pressure is going to eat it up initially. Hughes breaks containment.
Yep.
But good pursuit all the way through by the Chiles defense. Unable to stretch out and make the first down. Good close after the initial player press there by Chiles.
Yeah, so I'm not sure how much he lost in that play. It looks like he got back to the line of scrimmage. It's still going to bring up a third down and less than a yard to go.
Yeah, but it looked like pursuit out there on the perimeter, Tony. It was Jalen Taylor, Jaquez Dickey. But like we said, you know, so often we see quarterbacks reach the ball out, but they had his body turned in his strong, dominant hand. He was unable to do so. So good defensive effort finishing all the way through for Chiles. So third down and one, big conversion. Man, you think they run up the middle? Get a little play action, sneak in here.
There you go, right up the middle.
Right up the middle. Makes the first man miss into the second level of the defense inside the 40. And he's dropped down. A new running back on the scene, Tony.
Yeah, it was.
Big old breakout coming out of the backfield inside of the 35. Or excuse me, they're going to put the ball at the 38-yard line.
Yeah, number 24, that was the new running back.
Not on our roster, Tony.
Not on our roster, but he was able to pick up about 12 yards on that play. Picks up the first down into Chiles territory. Ball is going to be marked at the 38-yard line.
Absolutely. So
this is about where they started when they threw the interception on their previous possession.
There you go. So, of course, Tony, always some nuances. They sneak some guys in there. Who knows? Maybe just a uniform got caught on the in the washing machine, Tony, ripped it up, and he had to switch. So if you know who number 24 is, feel free to hit us up at VSN Tallahassee.
That's right.
Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. Send us a little message if you know on the JP2 side of things. We'd love to give this young man a shout-out. Beautiful rush on the play there, but number 24, so still looking for that number. Penalty on the play. They're going to back it up.
So
it's actually
going to
be a third and two. Take off the first down of the board, Tony.
Yeah. Excellent run by number 24, but off and out. Third down and 2 yards to go. Hughes in the shotgun.
So I think it was a holding about 10 yards down the field, and so or 9, 10 yards down the field, and so we get the holding call 10 yards from the spot. So it was after he hit the second level, thereby pushing it back just 1 yard. And I appreciate it, JP2 Football. Thank you, Kevis Thomas.
Kevis Thomas.
Number 24. So a well-deserved run on top of it. So
man,
shout out to JP2 Football
right on
Instagram. Thank you. Kevis Thomas, number 24. That'll be the first and only time that we do that again, Tony.
That's right. Look, you know it works, huh?
There you go.
It works. So fourth down, and JP Tua is going to go for it. The ball is going to be marked inside their own territory. They have to pick up a good 3 yards to get that first down, right at about the 49-yard line. It's going to be a timeout called by Chiles, as Coach Kevin Pettis wants to talk about this thing. And with that, let's see. You know, we want to remind you that you're watching VSN Tallahassee. Be sure to stay in touch with all of our athletic happenings around the Big Bend on our various social media outlets. Check us out at VSN Tallahassee on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Varsity Sports Network on YouTube. And, of course, as always, on the VarsitySportsNetwork.org. Big Bend.
Absolutely. And, of course, we're pumping it to you here on the VarsitySportsNetwork.org. Tony here, Big Bend channel, baby. Of course, we got a number of games going on this Friday night.
Yes, sir.
So whatever area of the state you are, if you've got some flavorings toward Daytona, Jacksonville, otherwise, check out the main homepage here, Varsity Sports Network. Should have some other games going on in your area.
Most definitely so.
But, of course, we appreciate you tuning in here to the Big Bend Channel. Tony Williams, Andrew Droop, Daniel Denoso, Walter Weaver bringing you the action here tonight. Of course, simulcast from our buddies at WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio. Tallahassee Sports Monster. Fourth down. Coach Hill says roll the dice and give it to Terrion Arnold. Let's see if he can beat the men. It's a two-on-one.
And he's
Arnold
still going.
Takes two men down. He's still trucking. They can't stop him, Tony. Inside the 30. And the big-time commit rumbles, bumbles, stumbles, Tony. Man, I was wondering if he was going to get past two guys, and then he took on two more.
Yeah, man.
A huge pickup, fourth down and two. And you got to love the trust that Coach Hill has. He puts it in the hands of his freshman quarterback.
Yeah.
You give it to your star player,
and
that's
not
a big payoff.
And, you know, that's not an easy throw to make, man. When you're throwing that ball wide out to your wide out, you're going to throw it 20 yards. It's got to be on time, and so it was. And that was just pure determination on the part of Arnold to pick up that first down. Moves the ball all the way down into Chiles territory. Ball is going to be spotted right at about the, looks like about the 30-yard line.
All right, get another scoring update from our buddy Big Bend Area Football Talk. Leon 14, FAMU 8.
Okay.
In the third quarter, excuse me. So thank you for the update there as we keep this thing on trucking, Tony. And we're getting a note here from a couple people on the gram. Of course, Nick and JP2 Football. Kevis Thomas, another one of those freshman phenoms,
wow.
Tony.
These guys are going to be so tough for years and years to come.
Keep on moving, man.
Freshman quarterback, they put in number 24, a freshman. I mean, I've seen, you know, a roster full of freshmen making big plays like they're seasoned veterans for JP2 all night.
And that's another thing, Tony. We talked to Coach, and he said Terrion's just been doing a great job. And it's not just kind of a one-stop shop. This is like, hey, guys, I'm the rock star of this team. You know, follow me. He said he's been doing a great job of mentoring these young guys and really upping the level of everybody across the board. And that's really cool to see. And, I mean, that's just not coaches talk, Tony, because we can see it firsthand out here on the football field.
Well, JP2 is going to take their second timeout. And while we have it, let's just remind you that high school football on VSN and 97.9 ESPN Radio is brought to you by Pepsi and Refreshment Services of Tallahassee. Pepsi-Cola employees eat, drink, live, and work locally. Pepsi and Refreshment Services, a Big Bend neighbor for decades.
There you go, Tony. There you go. Of course, enjoying a Pepsi beverage myself, and I feel like it's our weekly plug. You know, I'm sipping a little original Mountain Dew.
Yes,
here,
you
Tony.
Are. Yes, you are.
It has been a life partner for decades, Tony. Not quite to three decades, but definitely a couple decades.
That's right.
In the books here, Tony.
Yes, yes, sir.
Of course, being in the community, and no better community football here than in the South, Tony. Mm-hmm. He's getting with high school football. Man.
Yeah, man, on a Friday night.
Absolutely. And, of course, if you're interested in being a part of the sponsorship here, whatever you may be in, we'll get to that after this play. A quick hitter out to the outside. Good tackle on the perimeter there by Colin Farrell.
Yeah, man, I tell you what, Brown was just able to catch that ball, but Rodriguez was wrapping him up quickly for no gain on that play.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Like we talked about, Tony, if you want to be a sponsor as well, sponsor these high school athletics, allow people to get access for free and give your word to thousands of people, whether you're a politician coming up on election season, man, small business, big business, we do it all, my man.
That's
we'll
right.
work with you. Of course, a fellow small business here, born and raised here in Tallahassee, Florida, Tony. And we're getting ready for the fourth quarter of action. If you are one of those sponsors, Joop, J-O-O-P, at VarsitySportsNetwork.org. J-O-O-P, at VarsitySportsNetwork.org. We'd love to talk to you about some sponsorship options, Tony.
Yeah.
For as little as $25, so whatever your budget is, we got you covered.
We got you covered, man. And plus, guess what?
What's
football
that?
Season is fast ending. Playoffs are coming on, but
yes,
guess
sir.
What, Juke? We're going to be
up?
Getting into the round ball, man. We're going to be playing some round ball.
Yes, sir.
Some basketball season is starting just in time, man. That's my era right there.
There
little
go.
George Clinton, who incidentally lives in the Tallahassee area.
Okay. Here we go, a little snap for JP2, fourth quarter. They're now going to left to right. Out, it's Thomas in the space, and he's able to cash it in for a touchdown.
That is
Thomas. Strike. Kevis Thomas, the freshman, cashes
Man.
It in, and JP2 adds on to the lead.
Where did they have this kid hiding? JP2 out of Southwood in Tallahassee, and right across the hill from Florida High School.
Yes, sir.
And these guys have been, as we said earlier, man, St. John Paul, the second Panthers, have taken themselves a 26-14 lead with 11 minutes and 56 seconds left in this ball game as we are just starting the fourth quarter. And St. John Paul the second with a new running back in the game who has really just been doing wonders. And deep to receive for the Timberwolves. Looks like it's going to be Herring deep to receive. It's going to be a squid kick, and it's going to roll out of bounds at about the 24-yard line, so they'll either have to re-kick that ball or they will have to bring it out to the 35-yard line. Not sure exactly what coach wants to do. Get some good field position and get back into this ball game.
Yeah, absolutely. And something I can get back into is little Big Corey's Country Cooking, Tony. Of course,
yeah.
Our proud fourth quarter sponsor. Of course, fourth quarter of action brought to you by Big Corey's Country Cooking. The new taste, Tony.
Of the South Side.
The South Side, 1812.
South Monroe.
South Monroe is where you'll find Big Corey and the crew.
So here we go. Ball is going to be taken by number 6. He's going to hit the outside lane, and he's going to go all the way over. And he's still on his feet.
Wilshire.
Going to be pushed out of bounds at about the 30-yard line. Wilshire showing that electric speed that he has.
Woo.
And he ran that ball about 70 yards. And gets it into St. John Paul II's territory. Ball
Look
is going to be marked out at about the 30-yard line.
Look out, player. Tony, what who was it said? Was it LL Cool J? Don't call it a comeback.
Don't call it a comeback.
That's a great way. Hey, the quarterback helping his own cause. It puts Chiles on the 30-yard line. Kanari Wilshire with a monster return, Tony.
Yeah,
here in the Big Corey's Country Cooking fourth quarter of action. They must have got a little pick-me-up here getting at the end of the third. Maybe they have a little Big Corey's Country Cooking on the sideline, Tony.
Yeah,
you get
that
a couple scoops of mashed potatoes and all the great stuff they have going on there. That gets you off and rolling, man. I tell you what. So here we go. First down play is going to be stood up. Small gain there. Wilshire falls forward, though. Probably gets about 3
yeah.
out to the 27. So set up a nice little conversion here for second down.
Well, Wilshire is certainly not showing any ill effects from that earlier bump and bruise that he had.
Which is good to see. Good
yep.
to see.
Here, very good to see.
11:15 to go here in the Big Corey's Country Cooking fourth quarter of action. Wilshire looking over to sideline. Coach Pettis reeling in the information here. Ball favoring the left hash mark at the 27-yard line. Chiles going from east to west geographically, right to left on your TV screen. Full loaded backfield here. Two backs into block. It's a Wilshire design quarterback keeper, the old turf monster. Get him. And
yep.
Samaj James in there to reinforce on the tackle there.
Yeah, that's not going to be any gain on that play. It's going to bring up a third down and 10. Third down and 9 for the Timberwolves. And I'm sure being down by, about 12 points, I believe that they are probably going to go for it regardless.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Two downs to make 9 yards and to keep this drive alive for the Timberwolves. As the clock continues to run and they're taking their own sweet time, There are only 6 seconds left on the play clock.
5, 4, 3 seconds left on the play clock now. Wilcher out of the shotgun. 1 second. They just barely get it off. Design quarterback run. Trying to pick it up. Comes back against the grain. Has an avenue. Tries to cut back to the 25. Tyrion Arnold wraps him up and gets some reinforcements for the boys here.
Yeah, he's going to pick up about four or five yards on that play. A lot of whistles blowing.
Legal shift.
I thought I saw a little something on that particular play, so that's going to nullify a pretty awesome run by Wilshire and bring this ball back 5 extra yards instead of a 3rd and 9. It's going to be about a 3rd and 14 yards to go.
There you go, getting another scoring update from our buddy over at Big Bend Area Football Talk. Gadsden County shut out at halftime, 20-0 over the Arnold Marlins there, Tony.
Okay.
So, of course, maybe
Corey Fuller.
We'll get to this in the post game, but we had a couple guys on staff not going with the Gadsden County Jaguars here, Tony. Of course, we got a little fun little pick'em going here
between
the staff of VSN. And so that'll be interesting to watch. We all had a pretty good week last week. 7-2 for the most of us at a 9-game slate.
Yeah, well, I'm still a little bit behind you guys at 6-3.
Right in the wheelhouse.
Right, I'm in there.
About 2-3 games back. Big picture. I mean, we're all within 5 games of each other.
That's right.
So just a little fun activity.
Mm-hmm. 9:50 left in this Curry's Country Cooking fourth quarter.
Third down and long going here. Ball from the 34-yard line. Wiltshire's going to break to the outside. First down and more. And he's wrestled down about the 10-yard line. If not for Tyrion Arnold, Wiltshire's getting into the end zone.
Arnold Wiltshire is just putting this game in his own hands, man. Literally. And that's going to be a first down and goal. Ball is going to be marked right at about the, looks like inside the 10.
Yeah, it's like, where do you want it, Coach? A beautiful return there on special teams. Another QB keeper picks up a monster gain on about third down and 15. He's got him in the red zone. Wilcher with a keeper again. Going to go off tackle to the right. Surging inside the 10. And another good little pickup here on first down.
Yeah. That's going to move the ball all the way inside the 10-yard line now. It brings up a second down. And it looks like about 7 or 8 yards to go for a first. Ball is going to be marked. Looks like the ball is going to be marked at about the 9-yard line.
Absolutely. Loving the right side of that line. Credit to the big lineman up there, Major Hartman. Of course, a couple other big guys. Cooper Nice as well, putting in some work on the offensive line. And
there you go.
This one's going to run up the middle, and he's going to punch it through. And in with the touchdown, it's Jalen Herring, his second touchdown of the game for the Timberwolves. And we're back to a one-score game, Tony.
There you go. There you go. He just was a simply dive play right up the middle and was able to get into the end zone and tighten the score. As it stands now, 26-20.
So an odd dilemma here. You kick the extra point. It's a 5-point game. You go for 2. It's a 4-point game, Tony. The only benefit of going for
two
is you cut it to a 4-point game. If JP2 gets a touchdown, or excuse me, if they get a field goal, it's still a 7-point game, and you're able to keep it within that touchdown. That's really the only benefit, but it may be too early for that kind of talk.
Yeah, it is.
The extra point from Michael Smith is up and good. 5-point ball game, 26-21. Coming down to it, Tony, just what we wanted here down the stretch in the Big Chorus Country Cooking fourth quarter action here in the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week.
That's
simulcast
right.
On WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio.
Sports Monster. 9:01 left in this in this ball game. Unless we have an overtime, seems like an overtime in your opinion?
Uh-oh. Talking overtime, my man. Dangerous territory.
Yeah,
hey,
yeah.
I'll be down for it. A little free football for the people out here. Of course, free football streaming online with the Varsity Sports Network here. Always, you got your regular season action here on the Varsity Sports Network free of charge, baby. So thank you for coming aboard however you are with us. Hope you're enjoying it. Of course, if we got any kind of score updates, feel free to hit us up. Give us a follow anyways, Tony, at VSN Tallahassee, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Of course, also check out the YouTube, Varsity Sports Network. Got some nice little YouTube content up there. Blast by Michael Smith, and he's a touchback machine.
Yeah, he is. Yeah, he is. He doesn't play. He doesn't want any kind of run backs. No mistakes about it.
take it over. First down and 10 to go.
So it's going to be important for this defense to stand up for Chiles, see if they can put a handle on Hughes and his boys, because he has a lot of weapons at his disposal, and he's utilizing each and every last one of them.
Them boys, Tony. 9:01 here to go in the Big Four is country cooking, fourth quarter. And Tony, it looks like Kevis Thomas, the freshman running back, fresh off that monster touchdown run. He looks like he wants a little more, Tony.
Yeah, I'm sure he does. The ball is going to be marked at the 20-yard line, and that's where the Panthers are going to start this next possession. So here we go. Two back set, triplets. Two to the far side, one single. And Hughes gets the ball.
He's good play action over the middle. Almost intercepted.
Oh, my goodness. He's living dangerously out there.
Right about the 30-yard line. Beautiful jump of the route coming in for the far side. I believe, Tony, on the breakup was Anton Cooper, the junior jumping the route, Tony. But it's beautiful. A little double pump fake, and he read it the whole way. Yes, it was Cooper on the breakup, but excellent play by the DB there, Tony, to make sure that one was not completed. Of course, I believe he was looking for Vicker as his go-to man. Of course, two touchdowns. Two TDs for Vickers here tonight, and the give is to Jefferson, and he's got a lead block. It's Thomas with the block and Jefferson with the rumble.
Yeah.
Able to pick up 10, 11 yards on the rush. Move the chains, baby.
Yeah, more importantly, it's going to keep that clock moving with a six-point lead still. A five-point lead for the Panthers. And that's going to be a first down as the ball is going to be moved all the way up to the 30-yard line.
8:45 to go here in the Big Quarry's country cooking. Fourth quarter of action here in the Varsity Sports Network. Simulcast on WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio. So like you said, left hash marker, the 31-yard line. Need to get to the 41-yard line. JP2 going left to right in their navy blue and white uniforms, west to east geographically. Perpendicular, of course, to Thomasville Road. We can see the cars zooming by us, Tony. Jefferson trying to get outside. Man, when he gets outside, Tony, and turns the pad level north-south, he is like a locomotive train, Tony.
You don't really want to be in his way. It's like trying to hit Derrick Henry running down for the Tennessee Titans. That's a big guy as well.
Absolutely. About a 2-3 yard pickup. So they're going to stay with the two-back set, but it looks like Hughes is going to go under center, as they go with the split back. Looking over here near size, once James, early throw. And it looks like a little miscommunication. James looked like he was going a little curl route, and it looked like Hughes maybe wanted a post there. But
yeah, well,
that
ball,
incomplete.
That was also in danger of being intercepted on that particular play as well.
Absolutely. So here we go, third down, and this is one of those plays, Tony.
Yeah, this is this could be a crucial play for Chiles if they're able to get the ball turned over to them. We'll see. Third down, 8 yards to go for a first down. They've got to get the ball right past the 40-yard line.
Of course, only 7:47 here to go in the Big Chorus Country Cooking. Fourth quarter action. James makes the first man miss. Second man, too. He's got an avenue. He takes it over the 50, over midfield. A good tackle in the second level by Savion Knight. Tony.
Wow.
Savion, a really underrated DB in the area.
Yeah, he is.
And they haven't really thrown it his way, and I think that's why. But a great tackle by Knight out in the open field.
Yeah, well, you know what? Samaj James did a lot of that on his own, man, because he broke that first tackle, got into the secondary, and was off to the races until Knight was able to track him down.
Absolutely. Another one of the stars. More scoring update from App Ben Football Talk here. Monroe final, 56-0.
Wow.
And FAMU DRS storming back, Tony. 8 unanswered points. They're leading Leon 16-14 in the fourth quarter.
All right, Baby Rattlers.
Baby Rattlers trying to pull off a shocker, Tony. Of course, we picked the Baby Rattlers here in the game of the week. We might be gaining a little ground on the Twins, man.
Might be, man. Looks like that's going to be an infraction against the Panthers. Delay of game. They're taking a little bit too much time. I know they want to run off as much time as they can on that clock, but Hughes, being the freshman, he's got to implement that part of the game into his game as well.
Another thing to be considered. Another
thing
block,
to be considered.
Another building block. Of course, Hughes himself building. Like Coach Hill always says, building the foundation. We've sent it, probably 7-8 times?
Yeah.
Continuing to build, man.
Yeah, so, they're building, man.
Of course, it's some learning pains, Tony. We've seen him on both sides of the ball, but that's natural. That's part of the game. Every couple of years, you get that young rotation, and it makes him better in the long run. Better young man and better football players as a whole. Jefferson bounced out to the outside. Good pursuit by Charles on the next level, not allowing him to get north-south. Tony.
Yeah, they were able to stretch that play out, but he was still able to pick up about 3 or 4 yards on that play.
Savion Knight in on the bring down. A couple others in the area. Cooper also down.
So
Anton Cooper.
Yeah, the ball is going to be centered at midfield as the Panthers are trying to sustain this drive.
So here we go. Hughes, third down and long. Pressure, ball's on the ground. Diving on top of it. It's a dog pile. No ruling of who recovers. But it looks like JP2 recovers. But more importantly, it's going to bring up a fourth down. Excellent pressure from the D lineman of the Timberwolves. Getting in there, making the impact play, Tony.
Yeah, so it looks like we might be coming down to a very, very, very interesting ending as we have 5 minutes and 50 seconds left in this ball game.
Absolutely.
26-21 lead Panthers over the Timberwolves so far. But I tell you what, man, high school football on VSN and 97.9 ESPN Radio is being brought to you by the City of Tallahassee. The city offers a variety of grants, loans, and rebates on energy-saving items for your home. You can visit talgov.com for more information.
Yes, sir. And, of course, all to you brought to you by Pepsi and Refreshment Services of Tallahassee. Pepsi Cola employees eat, drink, and live, work locally. Pepsi and Refreshment Services, a Big Bend neighbor for decades and proud supporter of high school football on the Varsity Sports Network and 97.9 ESPN Radio. Of course, a proud participant here in the Big Bend, Tony, are we. I'm just glad that we're able here in this pandemic age do come to the football games.
That's right.
And, man, these young guys, they're really showing out, Tony, because
you've
got to recognize at any moment this could be the last football game of the year.
Hey, you never know, man. You just never know how things are going to happen. This pandemic is definitely not one that we can predict.
Jones with an absolute blast. He fields it, does Wiltshire at the 20-yard line, cuts back against the grain, and he's got a monster return again. Wiltshire coming near side and a big hit about the 45-yard line, laying down the lumber here for JP2.
That's Jaden Jefferson.
Woo.
Jaden Jefferson laid the lumber down, but I tell you what, Wiltshire is such an exciting player.
Look at that elusiveness, man.
Yeah, that elusiveness is something else, man. And here comes that big hit.
Boom. That's a body shocker right there.
Yeah,
that,
yes, it is.
That's a wake up on Saturday morning, and you feel that one.
Yes, sir. 5 minutes and 35 seconds left in this ball game, and the Timberwolves are trying their best to get back into this ball game and take the lead. Touchdown, of course, is going to win the game.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, it is.
But not if JP2 has anything to say about it.
So here we go. Ball's going to be marked at the 46-yard line. Another score coming from Leon and FAMU DRS. 20-16 now. Back and forth they go. Tony,
okay.
The Lions breaking through.
Go Lions.
So over on the left hash mark at the 46. Need to get to the 44-yard line. 5:35. Here in the Big Chorus Country Cooking fourth quarter of action and left in our ball game here tonight. It's become a back and forth affair, and Wiltshire has been the provocateur of late for the offense, and he keeps on trucking.
Wow.
And look at the second effort, Tony.
Yeah, second effort, and especially by the big number 71, who was able to help him across to get him to that first down.
One more time, shakes off a tackle, comes back.
But look at his big guard.
Helps him out. He's got four Panthers in there, five Panthers. But, yeah, to your point, Tony, you get by with a little help from your friends.
Yeah, absolutely.
Cooper Nice, number 71 on the offensive line, to your point, helping the cause a lot. Tony. Mm-hmm. Max Protect look, two running backs. Give his to Herring, and he's going to bounce out to the outside. Chiles has found some momentum. Here comes Jalen Herring on the perimeter, and he's tracked down around the 20-yard line. Vickers making the tackle on the outside.
Well, I tell you what, Wilshire and his running backs are really excited, this crowd, and I think that they have the momentum going. And it seems like anything that they're doing now, rushing the ball, they're being successful at it.
It seems that both teams, Tony, just been on their A game here.
Yeah, they have.
And we've seen kind of that third quarter, early fourth was JP2. And Chiles, just like in a heavyweight fight, Tony, they're coming back right, left,
right back
right,
at
left, right.
4:51 left in this ball game. And it seems like whoever has the ball last might be the winner of this game.
There you go. It's the Wilshire show, baby, here down the stretch for Chiles. Oh, look at the play action. Here comes the blitz. It's Samaj James. And yeah, great pressure. He's able to get the pass away. But the DB coming in from the second level.
Yeah, just
and Wilshire just saw just in time.
Yeah, he did. Because if he had not seen that, it could have been very well have been a fumble on that play. Because Samaj James was not playing.
Update from Lincoln Gabe, 24-14. Lincoln leading that one.
Go Trojans.
There you go. Once again, a little score update from our buddy Big Ben Area Football Talk on Instagram. If you know any area scores or know somebody that's going on in there, feel free to hit us up at VSN Tallahassee, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Rush to the outside here at Chiles. Jalen Herring brought down by Tyrion Arnold. Gets to about the 15-yard line. Going to set up a very short third down conversion here.
Yeah, Tyrion Arnold was holding on for dear life on that particular play, man. That's going to bring up a third down, as you said. Looks like about three or four, about 4 yards to go for a first. The ball is going to be marked right at about the, looks like about the 16, 17-yard line. And they've got to get to the 12-yard line to pick up that first down.
There you go. There you go, my man. And it has been picking up here, Tony. Chiles is finding what they want on offense here late in the second half. Herring going to go outside to the right, cutting back all the way to the left. 10-5, touchdown. Jalen Herring. And he's able to cash in the touchdown.
Yeah, man.
He's 16 yards out, and the crowd erupts here at Chiles High School.
Yeah,
and
man.
Chiles takes the lead back for the first time in quite some time, Tony.
Well, I tell you what, he ran. That was all him, man. He ran all the way to the right, reversed himself all the way back to the left, and was able to make that touchdown to give Chiles the lead as it stands right now. 27-26 for the Chiles Timberwolves.
You go for two right here, force the field goal.
Well, I think that, you know, that's what they say you should do, go for two at this point.
What's the old adage? The chart says two, Tony, the probability chart. Right.
There you go.
So a little bit of discussion going on here for Chiles. Play clock down around 15. Of course, game clock just under 4 minutes. 3:59 to go here in the Big Quarry's Country Cooking fourth quarter of action, Tony. But Jalen Herring, third touchdown. We talk about your big stars in big games, Tony. And we had a big performance here. Jalen Herring, now three separate rushing touchdowns, 2 yards, 8 yards, 14 yards, Tony.
Wow.
He did it about every way you can on
yeah,
the ground tonight.
Yeah.
Absolute dynamic performance for Heron. And he's really been the catalyst, along with Kenari Wilshire. This 1-2 punch in the running game has been mean for Chiles here in the fourth.
Well, you know, Heron came in as a star, and he's definitely has been showing his true colors tonight. Committed already to the University of South Florida, and they've got themselves a player. They've gotten themselves a playmaker.
Yes, sir.
So Chiles is taking a timeout in order for Coach Pettis to discuss what in the world he wants to do. Go for the one or go for the two?
That's
if he goes for the two and he doesn't make it, then we know that St. John Paul II does have a kicker, and all it would take would be a field goal to win the game.
There you go.
So I'm sure he's taking all of that into consideration. Going for the 2 points is going to be risky. Let's see what happens. But you may as well go for the two because 1 point doesn't matter anyway.
There you go. There you go. It all depends on which way you want to go, Tony. A great man once said, when you're sitting at the table, you got to know when to hold them.
You got
to
know
when to fold them, Tony.
That's right.
So are you folding here down the stretch? Big Corey's Country Cooking fourth quarter of action, Tony. on 97.9 ESPN Radio. You think they're going to go for the extra point?
Yeah, they're going to go for the two.
Prime time game of the week, baby?
Most definitely so. Here
Tag
we go.
Tag it up. Here, Herring going to go Wildcat. Double handoff coming the other way. Ball's on the ground, and JP2 recovers.
Yeah.
The conversion is no good.
The conversion
Jumping
is no
good.
Jumping
on top of it, Zion Perrette, the freshman, another freshman, Tony. The
My
wideout.
Goodness.
Delivering the boom and picking up the fumble.
3:55 left in this fourth quarter, and I tell you what, JP2 has a chance. That's enough time in order to get that ball down into Chiles territory. All they need is a field goal to win the game.
So there you go. Final score from Osceola. They've proved victorious on the road, 30-19. Good win over Bell.
Yeah. I think I picked them.
There you go, Tony. You're racking them up, my man.
Okay.
Getting going. Maybe getting some grounds.
Okay.
You may be able to get the saddle. Tony may be a lead horse by this time next week, my man.
Yep.
Of course, if you're looking for some more Chiles football, have a little rivalry week. Catch us Thursday night, Janet Gene Cox Stadium. We'll be the game of the week again here on the Varsity Sports Network. We're double-dipping Thursday and Friday again. So, Timberwolf fans, if you're not going to make the trip all the way down to the South Side, you got to hit us up. Check out at VSN Tallahassee on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. We'll have the updates for you, man.
That's
Kevin
right.
Pettis, Kenari Wilcher, Jalen Herring, and the boys will get him in prime time again. Oh, Arnold wanted to take that turn.
Yeah, he did.
Next year, he's running that out because he's going to be playing some big-time college ball.
Yeah, he's going to run that out next year, man, because he had about a 20-yard spot to get that big body in motion. And I tell you, not too many guys really want to hit him when he's in full motion.
I don't know if they can, Tony. He's been super elusive out here tonight.
All right, you got to play some DB, baby. Got to get on D.
Ladies and gentlemen, win or lose, you've gotten the price of admission out of this game for sure.
So as the parents are getting into the game as well, everyone is into this game, man. This is an exciting football game. And you know what? Every time we come over to Chiles, it's an exciting night of football.
How about that, Tony?
Yeah. Got to come more often, huh?
I guess that's what they're trying to tell us, Tony.
Yeah.
What's it called, Tony? In the psychological field, positive reinforcement.
There you go.
You reward good behavior.
You always do.
You encourage good behavior.
That's right.
So maybe we do need to take some more trips up here to the north side, Tony.
So there we go.
Out here, quick hitter to Samaj James. He's going to be wrapped up instantly. Jalen Herring's got a little something to give him after that
one, too.
Great open field tackle by the Chiles DBs.
Yeah, he's going to pick up about 2 or 3 yards on the play. It brings up a second down and 7 yards to go. And see if these Panthers can continue to move the ball, but they're going to have to get into a hurry-up mode and not take their time because there are only 3:28 and counting left in this ball game.
And they seem to thrive kind of in that hurry-up offense at the end of the first half, Tony. Oh, Hughes going deep looking for his boy. Oh, and he skips it in, incomplete pass.
Yeah.
Once again on the perimeter looking for Makari Vicker.
Yeah, well, I tell you what, Makari just was able to, he slipped down on that particular play.
Oh, the old turf monster, Tony. We talked about the moistness, the dew now setting in, but we had a little rain earlier. And if it rains heavy, the rain will sink through this turf.
Right.
But if you get a little drizzle, a little, you know, just like a little powdered sugar on the old donut, Tony.
Exactly.
That's going to sit on the surface. And
that's
right. Kind of what we're experiencing right
that's
now.
That's it.
Scoring update. Wakola 17, Columbia 15.
Good game.
2 minutes left in the third. Coming up here, shotgun look. Another third down, a pressure situation.
Up. Oh, that's going to be a motion on the part of came out of his stance. The tight end came out of his stance or the tackle. Not sure exactly what the call is, but it could be a 5-yard infraction against the Panthers. Let's get the official indication. Looks like they're not going to call anything. 3:48 left in this ball game as the crowd is getting whooped up. Third down, 7 yards to go. Hughes in the shotgun. He's going to go back to pass, and he's going to run the ball. Oh, he's going to pass the ball out to Samari James. He's going to have enough for the first down. And that was an excellent play on the part of Hughes, who kept his eyes open and his head downfield and was able to pick up his receiver in the flat for a 7 or 8 yard gain. It's going to be enough for the first down. But 3 minutes and counting left in this ball game, and the Panthers on the move. The ball is placed at the 34-yard line. Hughes in the shotgun. Hughes gets the snap, and he's going to hand it off to his running back. He's going to best off the right-hand side. He's still running. He's got that edge and is going to pick up the first down almost into Timberwolf territory. They'll be bumped out of bounds at about the 46-yard line. But it's, more importantly, it's going to be another first down for JP2. As the ball is marked out at the 46-yard line. 2 minutes, 24 seconds left in this ball game, Jupe, and I tell you, these guys are continuing to roll.
And here we go. It's going to be a play action. Beautiful fake by Hughes. It's just improv. He looks like Russell Wilson, and it's Hughes out in the open field.
He's going to score.
He's got nobody that's going to catch up. Tremaine Hughes.
Oh, my goodness.
Tony. 54 yards, Tremaine Hughes.
That's a freshman that did that, man.
Ooh-wee.
He scrambled that ball for 54 yards and a touchdown.
The freshman phenom, and here he goes, breaking the play. Nobody
touching
him
at all. He showed speed, poise, and durability on that particular play.
Well, Tony, that was a beautiful play call, and he played the play action beautifully.
Yeah, he did.
And then the way the play is set up, there's nobody on the left side, and so he's just trying to keep the play alive. He picks his head up. Nobody's over there, so he just bolts out there. But an awesome play there, and JP2 ripping back the lead. 207 here to go in the Big Corey's Country Cooking fourth quarter action here on the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week on WTSM 97.9 ESPN Radio, Tony.
Yeah, so they have a five-point lead. What do? Go for the two?
Well, Tony Chart says two, man.
That's right.
They've gone for it a couple times. Tony, we've seen a number of options. They tried the fade route down here to Samaj James. Last time they had the successful fade on the other side to Vickers. We also seen a couple rushes to the left-hand side. So we kind of seen a mixed bag. So I think all that to say is everything's on the table.
Everything is on the table. 2 minutes and 7 seconds left in this ball game, man. And JP2 has come storming all the way back.
Absolutely, man. This has been an absolute festive, fun, entertaining. Just when you think Chiles was going to run away with it in the first half, JP2 comes storming back.
Yep.
Just when you think JP2 is going to run away with it,
yep.
Chiles comes storming back.
Yep.
And like we said, evenly matched fight right now.
Yeah.
These teams each getting a couple shots in.
And guess what? You still have 2 minutes and 7 seconds left, so it's anybody's ball game still.
Yes, sir.
Especially the way the quarterback for Chiles, Wilshire, has been running that ball, man, and then handing it off to his running backs, spreading the ball around. I mean, it's going to be something else. We're coming down to the nitty-gritty.
Absolutely, man.
Hey, it's the nitty-gritty.
Tony, we talked about nitty-gritty in the capital city. We talked about the potential
like
for
that.
A little overtime, Tony.
Yeah.
That was kind of made a jest.
Exactly.
But if this is a successful conversion, we've got a legitimate shot, a little OT. It will be our first overtime of the season here, Tony.
Okay.
So here we go. It's going to be a shotgun set, sidecar left. Watch James isolation. Oh, here comes Tyrion Arnold. So they know it's a matchup here near side. It's a play action. Hughes to Arnold, and they're able to get the conversion.
Yeah, you got it.
And, of course, why not go to your big star? Seven-point game. Tyrion Arnold able to cash it in. 34-27, Tony. Wow, what a ball game.
Wow, what a ball game. 2 minutes and 7 seconds left, and the Panthers have taken the 7-point lead, and but it ain't over yet. It ain't over by a long shot.
No, sir.
2 minutes is a long time in a football game, man, and I believe that these guys have not given up yet. It has put a little silence on the crowd, which had been in
roar. I don't want to say an uproar because that sounds angry, but they were celebrating.
They were definitely celebrating.
Off. Yeah, they were having a good time.
Yeah, they were.
A raucous crowd.
Yep. Oh, my goodness.
And it was a little Tremaine Hughes put the kibosh on the party, Tony.
Well, I tell you what, man, I am so impressed with this guy, Tremaine Hughes, and I'm sure that if there is anybody from FAMU, FSU, or anyone in particular, any school close by, they're watching this kid and going to keep track of him.
Well, if you're not, you better start. And
yeah.
If you are, you better keep doing it, Tony. And you want to be one of these first ones to the table. Because Coach talked to us. He said, star in the making, Tony.
Yeah, he is, man.
Freshman.
Yeah, ninth grade. Was at Cobb Middle School last year.
Yes, sir. Monster kickoff. It's Wilshire. Talking about a star, a sophomore on the return. He's been absolutely explosive.
So and now we hear the crowd on the other side of the stadium going crazy as well, JP2, as they brought a very nice contingent of people out to witness this game as well.
Yes, sir. Southwood Pride coming up here.
Southwood
That's
Pride.
That's a long hike, Tony. Yep. Coming down from Southwood all the way up to the north side.
Yeah, man.
Terra Bone represented up here, man.
Yeah, man.
Making the journey down from JP2. They were here early, Tony, and yeah. They were here pretty big. Of course, limited numbers over on the away section, but a raucous, faithful crowd there for JP2.
So the ball is going to be spotted at the 21-yard line. They've got to get 79 yards in order to tie this game up. They've got 2 minutes and 2 seconds to do it.
Here in the Big Chorus Country Cooking fourth quarter of action, Tony. I mean, this is what you live for. Game on the line, fourth quarter, potentially final drive. Jalen Herring, a nice rush. Now that you got the gain, you get a little thing going here, and you want to start to pick up the tempo, because always in the back of your mind, tick, 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 tick. Like Chris Berman always so faithfully said, Tony, clock is rolling.
The clock is rolling.
Once again, going back over to the right side and then cutting back against the grain. Look at the second effort from Herring. Well, turns it into a 5-yard gain. Great pickup there.
Yeah, that second effort was what gave him a first down. So the Timberwolves are continuing to move the ball. Ball is going to be spotted at the 33-yard line. And more importantly, the clock is continuing to roll.
1:30 left here in the Big Chorus Country Cooking. Fourth quarter of action. 4 wide receivers set. Wilcher out of the shotgun. Sidecar to his right. Loading up. He's going deep. And he had a man over on the far side, unable to connect. Intended receiver Christian Corbett.
Yeah, I think that Wilshire had more time than he thought he had on that one. He had enough time to just sort of collect himself and complete that pass, because his receiver was breaking open. But as it stands, it's going to bring up a second down and 10 yards to go. The ball is marked at the 32-yard line. We'll call it the 34-yard line.
There you go. Another
minute and 20 left.
Another scoring update from our buddy at Big Ben Sports Talk here, our football talk. Lincoln 30, Gobbie 14 in the fourth. Madison County 28, Taylor County 7, also fourth quarter. So back and rolling here and now. It's Chiles and JP2, man. St. John Paul II. Second down and 10. Wilcher, a little bootleg. He gets rocked, but able to make the pass break up. Jalen Herring had him. Chance at it, but how about the defensive play by Devin Robinson?
Yeah, man, that was an excellent defensive pass breakup on the part of Robinson, and he jumped that route.
That was mean.
And you know what? He was just a split second away from picking it off and taking it all the way back to the house and putting this game completely out of reach.
There you go, Tony. It's about 9:40, so you think it's probably about after dinner for most of these guys, looking for a little dessert. It looked like Robinson was looking for some cookies, Tony.
Yeah,
almost
man.
Got caught in the jar, because if that's a little higher and Herring's able to rip that away, he's got a monster gain.
That's right.
He made a great jump on it, able to complete the pass breakup, and like you said, an opportunity at the pick six.
So here we go, third down.
You got to love your aggressive DBs, though. Wilcher with a sidearm. How about that delivery? Beautiful pass. Good reception by Trip Reagans in the middle of the field. I want to see that one more time.
Well, that ball is going to be completed up to the 45-yard line. It's a first down for Chiles.
Look at him whip it in there, Tony, on this replay right here. Zing! A little three-quarter. Reagans gets underneath of it. Pass completed. Move the chains, baby.
60 seconds left in this ball game.
And the Big Chorus Country Cooking fourth quarter action. Out to the perimeter, trying to dive out of bounds and save the clock here. But it looks like things will keep on rolling. We're under 50 seconds, approaching 45 here in the Big Chorus Country Cooking fourth quarter action. Second down and about 7 to go. Chiles pressing forward. They need a touchdown, and they need it now, Tony. Wilcher out of the shotgun. Sidecar left is Gullett. And we have a pre-snap stoppage of play
here. That's going to be illegal procedure called against, looks like it's going to be called against Chiles. That's going to back him up 5 yards.
With 32.9
seconds. 32.9
seconds
left in this ball game. The ball is marked at Chiles, in Chiles territory, at their own 44-yard line, 43. 32 seconds left in the game.
To second down and about 13 to go. Of course, need to get the 40-yard line and JP2 territory, but more important enemy is the clock. Here comes the blitz, and he tries to throw it away, and they're letting it ride as a potential fumble.
Well, they're going to say incomplete pass.
I think deservedly so. This may be in the area of grounding, Tony.
Yeah, very much so.
Intentional grounding.
It is going to be called an intentional grounding call.
So you can see him scoop up the what would be fumble there, but of course called incomplete, like we said.
Yeah.
Tumbling, bumbling, stumbling back. So, of course.
24 seconds left in this ball game. And you have to tip your hat to both of these teams, man, because they have battled tonight.
And how about the pressure? I love to dial up on defense. Mike Bergstrom coming on the late blitz, able to make the impact hit and play on the quarterback to force that issue. Oh, they're going to wave the flag off. There must have been a receiver in the area there, Tony. Or they're saying that the hit impacted the throw and forcing the incompletion. But
okay.
Either way. Regardless.
So they'll bring it back to where the original spot was. And it's going to bring up a third down. Or will this be the fourth down?
Big third down here. I think they'll keep it at three because they gave him the loss of down anyways. So I believe it is truly third down still. And seven to go here. Ball on the... Oh, a little stoppage of play coming.
This could be the play of the game, ladies and gentlemen. 24 seconds left. Third down long.
So a little correction for the referee. They just had to reset the, I think it was the play clock that was the issue. 24.4 seconds to go here in the Big Chorus Country Cooking fourth quarter. Wiltshire bootleg has to throw it in. Does! He finds Trip Reagan to the second level. The wide receiver, it is Luke Aiken. But there is a flag here right around midfield.
And it looks like number eight for JP2 is going to be hurt on
Vickers.
That play.
He's holding
that's
his
Vickers.
Left ankle.
Yeah, he is.
So while we have the opportunities, he's walking off. Tony, as you know, seeing is believing. That's why you need to see what's happening with Tall Timber Photography. Tall Timber cares about what's in front of the camera. That's you. Yeah, they have personalized consultations, and every edit is done by hand, so they're as unique as you are. No templates, no pre-made designs or awkward poses. Family owned and operated right here in Tallahassee, focusing on capturing the perfect moment as timeless today as it will be in 60 years. Tony, with next level experience shooting for the University of Miami and the University of North Florida, they're bringing the big leagues to your capture worthy moments. Whether it's high school sports, youth leagues, weddings, engagement, maternity shoots, they do it all, my man. You got to check out their deals and their beautiful pictures on their social media.
Yeah,
Facebook,
I can tell.
Twitter, Instagram, Facebook and Instagram, at Tall Timber Photo, at Tall Timber Sports. They got everything you need to see, man. Just a beautiful array of photo opportunities. Going deep, and it's incomplete. Terrion Arnold breaks it up on a big third down
pass.
Oh,
my goodness, man. I tell you what, that could have been the game that sealed the game. However, Terrion Arnold playing that free safety position was able to make up a whole lot of ground and break up that pass.
He looked like Mookie Betts tracking down a deep fly ball there, Tony.
Absolutely did.
Able to swat that one down. So, of course,
four seconds left in this ball game.
There you go.
Or is that 9 seconds?
That is 9.7 seconds here in the Big Chorus Country Cooking fourth quarter of action here, Tony.
Well, either way, I believe this might possibly be the last play of the game.
Well, they got to get at least short term. If they want to try to throw something to the sidelines, they're going to need about 18 yards back at the 37. They need to get to the 45. Wiltshire loading up into a big tuff of people. And Arnold is able to intercept this one. He's picking it back going the other way. 40, 30, 20. He wants a house call.
Yeah.
Cuts back against
the
grain. And Terrion Arnold in for the touchdown. And the big recruit, Tony,
and that
seals the deal.
That seals the deal all the way as Terrion Arnold was able to pick that ball off and race it back for about 80 yards for the touchdown.
How about that cutback, though, Tony? Last man to beat. Skirt. Getting the old Reggie Bush, man.
Absolutely. Wow, what an unbelievable game, man. And JP2 actually came through.
Absolutely. You can see one more time that cutback was absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, it was.
They seal the deal, Tony.
Yeah, they did. So these guys are definitely for real.
Of course, it was a one-score game coming down the stretch, but, of course, the exclamation mark, the seal the deal, Terrion Arnold, the big commit, pick six, Tony. It was about a 75-yard return for touchdown.
Yeah,
he emphatically sealed the deal for JP2.
And you know what? He was not going to be denied. Terrion Arnold picked that ball off, and he wanted that. And, you know, he could have easily have run out of bounds, but no. Let's get this baby all the way.
You got to have that for the highlight reel there, Tony.
Absolutely.
You got to put that one in, baby.
So you already know. Now, that makes his third interception of the night, his third interception on the season, and his second interception for a touchdown for the season.
Yeah, he had two picks tonight here, Tony. He had a pick. Jamash James had a pick. I mean, yeah. We saw everybody, all the stars going
come
on
out
for JP2.
Yeah.
And we learned about a couple new ones here,
yes,
Tony.
Yes, we did. Yes,
of
we
course,
did.
Of course, I'm sure the boys at JP2 would have told us what time it was. But, of course, we know about Kevis Thomas now. We know about Jefferson, the tailback.
Yeah.
I mean, we had a little knowledge of Tremaine Hughes.
Yeah.
But, man, did he look sharp today, Tony. Both of these young quarterbacks really blossomed tonight. Of course, Kanari Wiltshire, the sophomore for Chiles, the freshman, Tremaine Hughes for JP2. I was impressed on both sides, to be honest. So that will be just about all we wrote here, Tony, all that's on the agenda for this evening. I think the boys said it all in the field, and I think the people have had enough of us talking tonight, Tony, when it's all said and done. So for the crew here at Varsity Sports Network, Tony Williams, Andrew Jupe, Daniela Donoso, Miriam Obalabuntu, and Walter Weaver here on the game for you this evening. We wish you all the best. Thank you for coming aboard with us this evening. And make sure, as always, to stay tuned here on the Varsity Sports Network High School Game of the Week.
Thank you for watching this presentation of the Varsity Sports Network, brought to you by Big Corey's Country Chicken, the new taste of the Southside. White as Snow Cleaning and More, they do the cleaning so you can get back to living. And by the U.S. Army, be all that you can be. Any use of this broadcast or any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without consent from the Varsity Sports Network is prohibited. Thank you for watching.